Thank you for listening to GCN. Great talk radio starts here.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Here we are, ladies and gentlemen, busting out of the gates yet again. Like a cross between the Kool-Aid man and Schlitz malt liquor busting through the wall. What a ridiculous analogy. We're going to be here for the next 3 hours today. Jesse Ventura, who's been out of the United States the last 5 months, will be joining us today to talk about a host of issues, election 2012, the future of his TV show, Conspiracy Theory, that's mysteriously not aired, even though it's been done for 3-4 months. His lawsuit against the Navy SEAL, he says, lied that they ever met or that he ever punched him out or that Ventura ever said that he was glad that troops were dying. That is all coming up in the third hour today. In the meantime, I've really had time now to cogitate and to go through the permutations in my mind of what I really think about the Ron Paul, Rand Paul developments, with Ron Paul conceding on the same day that his son came out and endorsed Mitt Romney. And I understand both sides, those that are outraged by it and those that are saying, hey, this is political. But I can't help the fact that Ron Paul wouldn't do something like this. They say, well, Rand isn't Ron. But they advertised him as that. And, you know, the Iran's sanctions and, you know, spun that it was really anti-war. And then now the statements by the campaign that, well, you know, politically, this will make Republicans like us if we endorse Mitt Romney. This will make the party like us. We'll support the Patriot Act then. Support domestic checkpoints. Support drones in the skies. Support letting the military operate domestically. Support torture. And you'll be George W. Bush, and you can get the mainline country club rhinos who wouldn't know freedom if it bit him in the hind end behind you. I mean, there you go. So I don't think the hatred that I'm seeing of Rand Paul and Ron Paul right now, and I'd say 70% of people, I've seen the polls, the numbers out there, absolutely hate your guts now because they loved you. And so when they feel betrayed, it gets nasty. It's almost like a woman who's been scorned. She's got the, you know, hots for you politically, and then you slap her upside the head. I mean, she's going to hate your guts, something fierce. Another 20% or so say that they get it and understand why it happened to a certain extent, but still don't like it. And 10% are just sad. So I'm going to briefly, later in the hour, give you my take on that and some new developments. Some good news out of the Paul camp. Lawyers for Ron Paul file civil rights lawsuit. A Navy drone has crashed in Maryland. And they're announcing little bitty switchblade drones, which I knew about 12 years ago. They're basically model airplanes with a hand grenade or missiles. They can either fly into you and blow up or fire little missiles at you, shotguns, you name it. That's why when we did our drone shoot down thing a few weeks ago that went viral, drone shot down over Texas, if you haven't seen the video, you know, we point out a lot of the government drones are actually just consumer grade weaponized. And the meme by the jealous trolls of our viral video was, these aren't drones. Well, yeah, they're not predators. They're not reapers at 10,000, 30,000 feet. They are what you're going to be facing is just tons of super cheap weaponized drones, which police departments, yeah, I told you years ago they were going to weaponize drones. Oh, conspiracy theorist, fearmonger. Now it's happening. Hey, don't be a fearmonger. We need weaponized drones killing us. Government's been taken over. It's in an arms race against the people. It's a very simple equation. We're going to get into it. Also, carbon taxes being pushed on U.S. farmers. That's out of ABC. It's also happening in Australia. Continuing here, Congresswoman lashes out at TSA for hiring pedophiles and child pornographers. New article on that. And there's a new video out of a woman screaming, she's molesting me, somebody help me. Woman passenger cries for help at airport. after security of invasive search by female TSA. Why don't they hire Jerry Sandusky?
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup insurance and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365. Hi, folks, this is Alex Jones, and I want to tell you about the Silver Lungs Generator. Now you can produce pure and endless colloidal silver and deliver the solution directly into the bloodstream by breathing the solution through the lungs. The respiratory system is the first line of defense for airborne pathogens and viruses. The Silver Lungs Generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced nano-silver solutions and also delivers the silver nanoparticles instantly into the bloodstream. With continued legislation threatening the sale of nano-silver products, you can now produce pure and endless colloidal silver with the Silver Lungs Generator. Very easy to follow, step-by-step instructions are provided, making production fast and simple. Go to www.silverlungs.com today and learn more about the breakthrough technology of the Silver Lungs Generator. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
You have found it, the front lines in the info war, the tip of the spear. I'm Alex Jones, your host, dedicated to liberty, freedom, the Constitution, the Second Amendment, private property, family, small government, liberty in our time. I want to win the future, as Obama says. I want to win it from globalist criminals and their front men like Barack Hussein Obama. Former Minnesota Governor Jesse Ventura, fresh back from Mexico, has filed suit, and it's already started to go to court, against the Navy SEAL sniper that claims he punched him out. Jesse Ventura has the owner of the bar and other Navy SEALs ready to go to court that it never happened. Total baloney. But that's not the main reason Jesse's joining us. He'll give us his take on election 2012, Rand Paul endorsing Goldman Sachs minion Mitt Romney, and more coming up in the third hour today. In the meantime, Hillary Clinton is calling for airstrikes and ground forces, and you've seen the Secretary of Defense calling for boots on the ground in Syria, and even mainstream news admits that it's actual al-Qaeda. Just type in al-Qaeda in Syria, al-Qaeda uniforms, al-Qaeda flag in Syria, and it is real al-Qaeda wearing black al-Qaeda uniforms with the al-Qaeda flag engaging in massacres, blaming it on Assad, blowing up buildings, bombing police stations. And it just shows the utter and total contempt that the globalist and the controlled collaborator media have for the people of America and the West, that they're like, oh my gosh, give all your rights up. Al-Qaeda garden gnomes are hiding under every bed. But Al-Qaeda is being used to attack the Serbs again. Real Al-Qaeda. Al-Qaeda is being used to run drugs out of Albania. Al-Qaeda is being used against the Iranians. Al-Qaeda is being used everywhere. And there's an article at Infowars.com saying U.S.-Israel attack on Syria, you know, goes into overdrive. Israel actually doesn't like the Arab Spring, at least on the surface. Israel, actually, there's some evidence, is propping up Assad to a certain extent because they understand this is part of a larger order out of chaos situation. That's why you've had the former head of Mossad and most of their military come out and say, don't attack Iran. This will create a global conflagration. So it's not all just one monolithic situation that's unfolding here. This is all part of the order out of chaos strategy, like putting Al-Qaeda in, NATO funding them to go in and take over Libya and run up the Al-Qaeda flag. I mean, this is in the LA Times. This is in Reuters. They don't even deny it, but they report it very calmly. That, oh, yeah, okay, yeah, Al-Qaeda out of Saudi Arabia, yeah, yeah, some of the folks have, here's their names that fought U.S. forces in Iraq. Yeah, and then they quote them going, I kill Americans in Iraq, now I kill Gaddafi. And it's like, what? 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 And again, there's that disconnect here where we're told the police have to pull you over and take you to jail if you got marijuana on you, but our troops for a decade publicly grow the opium and load it on C-130s and fly it into the Europe and the United States. And they show the troops growing it and guarding it. And they go, well, we have to do this or Al-Qaeda will get it and make money. What? Al-Qaeda was created by the globalist. The real Taliban, the one that said, show us the proof of Al-Qaeda doing this, we'll hand them over to you for 9/11. Those are the guys that got arrested. The establishment Taliban, they got flown out to safety. That came out in the Financial Times of London, Newsweek magazine. I cover it in my film, Road to Tyranny. Opium production went from less than 10% to 93% in 2011. We haven't gotten new numbers for this year yet. Look it up. 93% of world opium production from less than 10% under the Taliban. Oh, yes, the troops better help grow it or the Taliban and Al-Qaeda will get the money. NATO uses Al-Qaeda to control Kosovo and Albania to ship the goodies by ground as well all over Europe. This is not debated. There have been countless whistleblowers in NATO, in the UN, about this. NATO is a narcotics and sex trafficking organization. Look it up. Just type in NATO sex trafficking, UN sex trafficking, NATO drug trafficking, UN drug trafficking. I mean, we're talking about, that's where the $500 million a year in opium out of Afghanistan, opium, heroin, cocaine, all of it here in the U.S. alone, $500 billion a year. $500 billion just in what's consumed here. And again, you know the big banks are laundering that, and they're constantly caught doing it. We deposited money in a local bank. I'm like, you know, we shouldn't use big national banks. You know, we have an account for the InfoWars operation and payroll in a Texas bank, but it's still globalist connected. Let's go to a really, you know, smaller bank. So we start putting money in there that we pay for everything with. And it's all coming directly from, you know, companies, advertisers, things like that. And they call up my wife and they go, well, what is this money? We have to prove this isn't laundered money. And we're like, you have to, you know, we have to investigate this. And we're like, really? Well, the big banks launder drug money publicly. And you can just type in Alex Jones and the name of the company. It's a media operation. This is advertising stuff. And it's not even that much money. And you got hundreds of billions being laundered a year by these big banks. And then you start depositing, you know, $50,000, $60,000 to pay for the rent and the employees, you know, payroll and the power bill. And it's like, oh, what is this money? What is this money with the business account? What is it? What is it? I mean, mean, it's a joke. The whole police state is focused on the law abiding, absolutely in our face. I've tried to go in before and said, I want $3,000 cash. Well, what do you want that for? Sorry, we don't have it. Okay, I'm leaving this bank. Well, we're going to file a report on you. Well, file one with the narcotics trafficking government. Shut up. All right, I'm going to stop right there. I've got all this news and I'm already digressing. It's just so frustrating to have criminals running the government and the big mega corporations, and they've got the total police state behind them and the regulators behind them, and they do whatever they want. And then you now, even in Texas, you drive up to an illegal checkpoint, been ruled illegal, and the cops want to search your car. And it's like, this is a joke. This is not about my security. This is about a police state. A police state never brings you security. And the founders spoke of this, every major historian, this is common sense. We know the road we're going down leads to a very, very bad place. And if you think Mitt Romney's going to save you, I got a bridge I'm going to sell you. And no, Obama won't save us either. They're puppets. They're puppets. Only addressing the puppet structure will ever reverse anything. And you can't make a deal with puppetdom to have the puppet system think you're nice. And I'll cover this now, and then I'm done talking about it today. Then I'm going to get into all the other news. And boy, is there a lot of it. The Ron Paul, Rand Paul bashing and anger has gotten out of hand. We cannot let the fact that Rand Paul is becoming a mainline Republican make us all tear each other apart. We're still going to agree with him on the Second Amendment. We're still going to agree with him on national sovereignty, the border, on not arresting people that sell raw milk. I mean, marijuana decriminalization, things like that. He is becoming neoconish on sanctions and wars. It's very sad, and he has endorsed Mitt Romney. And the response by the campaign is, hey, this is a quote I read yesterday by Jack Hunter, the official response, was, hey, Republican mainline people won't like us if we don't endorse Mitt Romney. Well, then, I mean, if you believe that, Ron Paul should have endorsed all the wars, not audit the Fed. You know, okay, I mean, we get it. There's no reason to be angry at Rand Paul or hate him. I understand people get angry because they feel like it's a betrayal. But they want to say, hey, Rand is not Ron. Okay, fine. And Ron wants to coordinate things with him, announcing that, you know, they're not going to do anything with the delegates now. And that's all over. I mean, we knew it was over. I didn't like the playing people the last few months as if they were still going to win or something. Ron Paul supporters were calling me going, hey, the campaign says we're going to do something big with the delegates. And I said, you watch, they're not going to do that. And so I'm irritated by that. I'm irritated by him endorsing folks that are, you know, pro-property tax and CFR. I mean, there's been a lot of bad signs. And it's not like we have to feel bad in the gains we've gotten. The fact that Ron Paul, being anti-globalist, pro-constitution, really won the first few states and created such a phenomenon against the Republican establishment shows that the ideas of liberty can take over the Republican and Democratic parties, but at the grassroots. You're going to have to do it. And don't think you're going to get, because I've seen them campaign for liberty. This is the real issue. Go over people that are Ron Paul types and go for establishment people. So Campaign for Liberty, we hope, will reverse what they're doing. But from the responses we've seen, it doesn't look like that's going to happen. And so there's not going to be hatred or anger. I'm not going to ever seek to get Ron Paul on this show again. Rand Paul, I'm done with them. Okay? I don't dislike them. I will remember them, who they were, fondly. And I will time from time when they do good things, point it out. And when they do bad things, I will point it out. They're just people kind of transferring into rhinos. Rand certainly is. Ron is not speaking out against it. And so, I mean, Rand comes out of him, comes out of his movement. We brought Rand to the table. And so Ron not criticizing this is a coordinated nod to it. So that's fine. That's your choice. I've seen publications come out here. Here is one out of NJ.com, the big New Jersey paper. It says, two words for those upset by Rand Paul endorsement of Mitt Romney, grow up. Well, you know what? I am going to grow up. And break with the Pauls. So, okay, I grew up. And I'm going to come back with the condescension out of these folks on the other side with this. But no, I mean, I'm grown up. I understand. You've got the Republican Party and Fox News now. You don't want us. You don't need us. In fact, they even say that in these articles. I understand.
Are you still a traditional smoker? Now experience a new lifestyle and try vaping with e-cigarettes by LeCig. Imagine no ashes, stains, nasty smell, or coughing and hacking. With LeCig e-cigarettes' revolutionary microelectronic technology, rechargeable battery, and unique replaceable cartridge, you'll get all the benefits and satisfaction of smoking without the hazards. Choose your taste from a wide variety of our new American-made Vaporeon e-liquids at LeCig.com. And LeCig smokes the competition by serving thousands of worldwide customers with real people customer service, fast, free, same-day shipping, and a 30-day warranty and satisfaction guarantee. So are you ready for a new vaping lifestyle? Then call 870-518-4307. That's 870-518-4307. Or visit LeCig.com, spelled LeCig.com. LeCig e-cigarettes for today's modern smoker.
In an emergency situation, would you drink contaminated water? You could if you had the amazing Life Straw from MyPatriotSupply.com. Life Straw is the most advanced personal water filter available today. It filters contaminated water from almost any source. Life Straw is lightweight and compact, perfect for hiking, camping, or in an emergency like a flood. Life Straw is easy to clean, comes with a 1-year warranty, and has been used worldwide since 2005. Get the amazing Life Straw personal water filter at MyPatriotSupply.com. Plus, check out Survival Seed Vault, 20 seed varieties for only $37.95, Tattler canning lids, long-term storable foods as low as $69.95, and much more at MyPatriotSupply.com. Enjoy stress-free shipping on all orders over $49. Call 866-229-0927 or visit MyPatriotSupply.com. That's 866-229-0927, MyPatriotSupply.com, for emergency preparedness, self-reliance, and food independence.
HempUSA.org has moved and expanded its operations for faster worldwide shipping. Our product line has grown from 5 to nearly 100 items in less than 5 years. Our food is grown naturally, always chemical-free, not found in stores. Great for daily intake and perfect for your emergency storage shelter. Call 908-691-2608 or visit HempUSA.org and see what our powders, seeds, and oil can do for you.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Hi, Ted Anderson. I'm placing a silver dollar in a book explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
We all know that Berkey Water Purification Systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey Guy offers amazing specials for Berkey Water Filtration Systems. The Berkey Light Systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey Light System today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey Guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey Light, the Berkey Guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey Guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at GoBerkey.com. That's GoBerkey.com today.
Well, I tell you, this has been going on for a long time, the preparations for this. Bob Chapman had sources inside U.S. embassies that told us this over a year ago. God rest his soul. But here's the articles out of Associated Press. You name it. They're up at Infowars.com, boiled down in an article by Kurt Nemo, Globalist Plan, European Union, Police State Lockdown. DrudgeReport.com also has these articles. EU movement of money, people can be limited. That's the financial dictatorship. Those are called capital controls, and that's what the TSA is already doing. They ask you, what's this jewelry? What's this silver coin? What's this diamond? They're even questioning people's diamond rings now. I mean, it's beyond Guatemala or Nigeria. I mean, you want a front row seat to tyranny? The bankers didn't set up this police state because they wanted to play patty cake with you or keep you safe. They did this because they're going to implode things by design, as I've been telling you for over a decade, really 14 years, since I had economist George Humphrey on and others, who said they're going to sell the world their fraudulent directives and their fraudulent derivatives. People, governments are going to sign on to those as too big to fail, and then they're going to raise taxes across the board to bankrupt the middle class and working class to transfer the money offshore. And it's now happening. They have appointed leaders now in places like Italy. They are calling them technocrats. And now they're saying, you know what? You're not going to get your money out of the country and you're not going to withdraw. And we're going to have bank holidays. And then after that happens here, I've talked to high-level stockbrokers, high-level government officials, and I've talked to other prominent people who've been told the exact same thing, that within a few months of this happening in Europe, they plan to bring it here. Now, exposing it may make them not do it, but if the cops all get in line and the military all gets in line, and if you get in line, they're going. There's a Federal Reserve report out today in the Associated Press where they said, since 2008, we've lost 40% of America's wealth. How do you do that? Well, when you base it all in fiat garbage and let $1,500 trillion be created that you're then signed on to, it's impossible to pay back. It's there to always rope you into paying into it to wreck the society. It's an anchor. It's a trillion-pound ball and chain. Yeah, there it is. Fed reports how much recession shrank U.S. wealth. Folks, it says 40%. That's a depression. And you notice we never left it. They told us 3 years ago the recession was over. It's all lies. But look at these headlines. EU movement of money, people can be limited. Associated Press. I've been telling you for years they're getting ready for that. Oh, that's that fearmonger. Hey, they're going to have weaponized drones in every city. Oh, shut up, you crazy. Hey, they're going to have RFID in all the products and tax you according to each item with RFID readers. It's going in Europe. Oh, it'll never happen. Oh, Miami just passed it? Oh, but I'm making it up. And again, people think if they just deny it, it'll be okay. No, it's not going to be okay. The more gullible we are, the worse it's going to get. Look at this. Discusses limiting ATM withdrawals. Disaster scenarios. Again, these are controlled disasters that they pose as the savior. You've got IMF chief Lagrand, IMF chief, warns world risk triple crisis. Oh, if you don't do exactly what they say. And it only gets worse each leg. We told you what would happen in 08. We told you how it would move to Europe and then back here. It's all been planned. And what does Lagrange say? This woman who's even against her own country. She's an Anglophile who hates the Francophiles, literally. She's known for that. This is a traitor against her country. And what does she say? She says, you need to shut up in Greece and pay more. By the way, she's exempt. The EU bureaucrats, look this up, are exempt from the taxes. I mean, you cannot imagine. I cannot imagine the magnitude, the sheer magnitude of the end your face arrogance and criminality of these commissars. And who sold Greece and Italy and Spain and the U.S. and all of them to sign on to the derivatives? Again, this isn't even derivatives the countries invested in that went belly up. That's part of the debt, less than 10%, if you look it up. And other entitlements, which are just there to entice you to sign on to the too big to fail. You know, you'll lose all the entitlements if you don't sign on to our too big to fail. It's their debt, and they're saying you're going to pay more. People are committing suicide en masse in Greece. They're dumping their children off at government facilities. The orphanages are overflowing. And the media says, oh, they're just lazy. Yeah, next you'll hear Americans are lazy, working on average three jobs. All right, Anyway, I'm going to finish up with this and then briefly the Rand Paul thing and then a big transhumanism report I was going to get to yesterday and then your phone calls and then Jesse Ventura and big TSA molestation news. Again, I'm serious when I say this. They're hiring known child molesters to run every TSA facility. Why not just hire Jerry Sandusky?
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for survivalseedbank.com.
For a long time, you've heard me talk about building your own food supply with eFoods Direct. As a listener, you know why you need to have a supply of the best storable food on the planet. Every day, we document the attempts to take control of our lives. But there's one thing we can all control, your greatest dependency, food. eFoods Direct products are made with only the best ingredients and none of the trash and contaminants like trans fats, GMOs, or MSG. This food is nutrient dense and tastes great. It's simple to make, portable, and has a shelf life of up to 25 years. Now with eFoods Direct, you'll get the most affordable, best tasting food you can buy. And the new products and pricing will blow you away. Compared to other food sources, including home cooked meals, you can cut your food cost in half. You just can't afford to ignore this. Call 800-409-5633. Or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex for specials. Don't let this offer pass you by. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. More the best for less guaranteed.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it. Others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond Gusset Jeans. Made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond Gusset Jeans got it. Others don't.
The IMF went down to Georgia. They were looking for a country to steal. They were in a bind because they were way behind.
The devil went down to Georgia. He was looking for a soul to steal. He was in a bind because he was way behind and he was willing to make a deal. When he came across this young man sawing on a fiddle and playing it hot, and the devil jumped up on a hickory stump and said, "Boy, let me tell you what. I guess you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you'd care to take a dare, I'll make a bet with you. Now you played pretty good fiddle, boy, but give the devil his due. I bet a fiddle of gold against your soul, because I think I'm better than you." The boy said, "My name's Johnny, and it might be a sin."
Oh, man, it is hard to turn off.
"I'm the best as ever been."
The gentleman singing right now. Especially when I know the fiddle playing is coming up. And by the way, we are going to get Charlie Daniels back on the broadcast. He is really waking up to the entire New World Order program. Oh, this is a good part right here.
The devil opened up his case and he said, "I'll start this show." And fire flew from his fingertips as he rosined up his bow. And he pulled the bow across the strings and it made an evil hiss.
And a band of bureaucrats joined in. It sounded something like this. All right, I'm going to stop right now. That's enough. Thank you so much for that devil went down to Georgia. Okay, let me just mention the news I've got here. Let's just start over here on the right. On the border, guns, drugs, and a betrayal of trust. CNN. Why, local towns caught selling guns to the Mexican drug cartels. So they want to muddy the waters, talking about local corruption as well and the loss of trust. What about a story CNN about the tens of thousands of U.S. troops killed in secret chemical, biological, and radiological tests that have been declassified right through the 1980s and are still ongoing? You know, private, go in that room, nerve gas them, and then dissect their body and tell mama they died from the flu. You think that might be newsworthy? No, 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 no. That's so off-the-chart evil, CNN isn't going to tell you about it, even though it's a fact. See, when I see an article like that, that's what I think of. Oh, there was a loss of trust. The mayor and police were selling guns to drug dealers. Really? You think so? You think that might happen? Only naive morons don't know that's going on. I'd say half the towns in this country have narcotics, prostitute-running police departments involved in every evil you can imagine. And then you've got the other half, generally, who aren't involved in any corruption at all. It's like either or, generally. You've either just got absolute corruption or you don't have hardly any. Because that's how things work in this world. They want to tell you it's all a bunch of gray stuff going on. Not in my experience. It's either they're not corrupt because they're not corrupt and it never gets started, or they're just totally corrupt. You know, I've had Frank Serpico on this show. Let's get Serpico back on. That was a big brownie point for you, getting him, John Bowne. He was a listener, by the way, once we got him on. That was amazing. I want Frank Serpico. I'm like, how many of the other detectives were dealing drugs? Oh, 100% other than me. I thought it'd be like 75% because I had another detective on who was from New York before Serpico's day. I forget his name. It was like in 2000, probably dead now, but he was in there in the 50s and 60s, and he said about 75%. And that's who they had to fire, was that many. Now they don't fire people for that. They kill you if you expose it. So what do? You decriminalize it so the police can't be corrupted by it. And then you regulate it like alcohol or something, and the tax people are so greedy, they'll make sure there's no black market in it or not as big a one because they're greedy for their money. You see, but instead the banks get all the money by making it illegal and your house gets robbed so the druggie can get the overpriced drugs. You knock down the price of the drugs, say 500%, all the money's out of it. All the little pimp drug dealers can't act tough all day and drive around in fancy cars. What drug dealer wants drugs to be legalized? The answer is zero, 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 zero. All right, I'm going to shut up. I just mentioned one article, never got to the others. Here's the big article I was just mentioning. Globalist plan, European Union police state lockdown. That's always been the plan. We told you that was coming. None of this is a brand new idea. The breakup is into the authoritarian state, holding everyone hostage, getting more power each step every year. Give us trillions more. Give us total control. This will fix it. You'll still get your pensions, police, as long as you shoot protesters. You'll still get your money as long as you don't let folks have their money. And then, of course, you'll end up losing your money in the end as well. European Union apparatchiks are preparing to lock down Europe following Greece's exit from the euro. And again, it hasn't exited yet, but they're talking about it. And they're openly saying that they will control ATM withdrawals, subjecting the citizens of member states to rigorous border checks, imposing capital controls as a worst-case scenario should Athens decide to leave the euro, Reuters reports. And again, they'll suck Greece a lot more dry than the other countries before they do that. Greece is 2% of the economy over there. It's a total red herring. But you notice they left all the big border checkpoints in and set up internal ones within the countries. They got rid of the borders being manned most of the time, to let all the foreigners pour in to take jobs and drive down wages and be blocks that would vote against the regular citizens. Now, though, they're announcing, and this was announced a few weeks ago, but only because they were having some summits, but now it's going to be permanent. Oh, we're sorry. The foreigners come in. Oh, come on into the mousetrap. Come on into the roaches come in, they don't get out, but you're not leaving. Yeah! Yeah, That's why they got Border Patrol all the way up in San Antonio now, pulling families over. They don't stop illegal aliens. We're the feds, and we're here to search your car. Why are you here? Because the TSA inspector said so. You want to be slaves? You're getting front row seats to it. And here come the little switchblade drones the police departments are going to get. With gas, grenades, 12 gauges, here come the switchblades. All your money to build a giant army against you, because the Pentagon's been told and NATO announced earlier this week, they now openly work for the New World Order. Our military is no longer ours. It has publicly, without even an issue being raised, the Joint Chiefs, the chairman, the SecDef, Obama said, we get our orders from the United Nations and NATO. And we don't come to you for a jack squat. Now sit there and do your insider trading and have sex with your prostitutes and your pages, Congress. Shut up. We have all the dirt on you, filth. Shut up. And they're like, yes, sir. And that's the end of it. The question now is the military and police wake up? The military, sure, they gave Ron Paul most of their contributions. Sure, they're awake. A lot of cops are awake. They're not total criminal thugs. And, but, I mean, I don't know. I mean, and let me tell you, everything's going to be destroyed. This is the plan. They've already cut 40% of our wealth in 5 years since 07, 08, and they plan another 40%, and they're going to take it all. And people are going to be thankful for what they get. The poorer they get, the more they're going to beg to the government. And you're going to get used to the drone flying by and watching you right out of they live. Hello there, my little friend. Mommy don't like tattletales. Well, mommy does like tattletales and land of the coward, home of the slaves. So it is an amazing time to see all this happen. You know, I kind of went off on a rant yesterday, or was it Sunday, about every time they have the Republic of Texas biker rally in Austin, over 100,000 bikers come to the town of a million people. And they had, what, 4 deaths over the weekend? And some city people said, ban the rot rally because of the deaths. No, you bring in 100,000 people. You know, that's freedom. They don't want to wear helmets. They want to be idiots. They want to do that. That's their issue. What I don't like is most of the motorcycle folks are nice people. But a lot of them, and they say it's like Sodom and Gomorrah down at the convention center, you know, sex in the open, fights, everything else. And it's left alone because the cops are intimidated by a bigger gang. And it's mob psychology. That's why most militaries end up raping, killing, slaughtering women, children for fun. A lot of our military did in World War II. George Washington, there was almost none of it because he would hang you for the smallest infraction. That was one reason we ended up winning. The British were raping, killing, you know, burning down churches. Washington understood, he was also very moral, that was a big no-no, and that's how you lose the hearts and minds. So if you did anything like even grab on a woman, he just had a on-the-spot court-martial, and they strung you up. In fact, in military, historians will tell you, even foreign ones, that that was one of the only militaries and periods where there was almost no massacres or rapes or lootings. Because George Washington would kill you if you did. It wasn't a debate about it. They would hang you or shoot you right there on the spot. And But this is mob psychology, and so I've been at a motorcycle rally just because I was at the South Padre Island area when one was going on, and I hadn't and they were running around acting tough and bugging their eyes out and driving up with their motorcycles, acting like they were going to run into my kids, and I mean again, I don't claim to be a tough guy, but you menace my 3-year-old. I mean, I'm ready to kill you. I mean, I'm going to break your neck, buddy. I mean, you're about to get assaulted, and I mean viciously. And I mean, because I'm normal, folks. I'm like a dog. You attack my puppy, I'm going after you. I mean, there's not a, I'm like a raccoon. I mean, I'm just normal. I'm still wired straight ahead. And I watch the, it's like police. That's why the average cop is nice. They've done studies. But they get them in black uniforms. They put masks on them to take their anonymity. I mean to give them anonymity. Mexico has it. Russia has it. They'll do horrible things when dressed up like Darth Vader, and at night, and let's go find somebody to beat up because we're all dressed up like this, and people do horrible things. That's why executioners wear black masks to hide their identity. So you get all these motorcyclists in their outfits and all the different gangs and groups, and they're all there. And I take my children, My dad heard the story and was disturbed by it. I mean, I was just being honest about how I felt. I was going into, you know, absolute assault mode. And I'm walking with my three children to take them in to eat at a pizza place. They asked to go to the mall and eat the pizza place. And they go to the Lego store. And every few months I take them to do that. And we're going in, and I'm walking along the sidewalk, along the side of the mall, going into California Pizza Kitchen. And a guy all the way on the other side at the big entrance has his bike parked illegally up on the sidewalk. I was thinking, oh, that's a cool-looking bike. I like those style where the bars are straight, more that old-fashioned look. And he fires it up, and he looks down the sidewalk. And there's ramps where people walk up right by him. And he looks at me, and he sees my kids. And he revs it up and comes right at us. And I started pushing him aside and was thinking, okay, control yourself. Just push him up against the side of the wall. And I was just making the decision. I can't help it, though. I'm gonna jump on him, though. And then the split-second calculation's happening. You can get hurt. Then your kids are left at the mall. And so I'm right at that point of my computer, my brain, making the decision. And he cuts off and runs down an embankment 15 feet in front of me. And I just thought of what type of person sees a man with children and thinks that's a weak person and thinks someone with children is weak and not tough because I wasn't wearing black leather and strutting around, you know, all day, and then wants to menace somebody. I mean, it was just like, and it was very stressful because I had to go through, okay, this guy's looking right at me. He's rushing probably 50 miles an hour in a matter of seconds. Shoots past us and just roars down, almost hitting cars coming around the corner. I mean, this guy, and again, four of them, what is it, four I heard today? Four of these people died. One of them ran off an embankment down off a Mixmaster and fell 40 feet to their death. I mean, these are just crazy people. And my point is they'll risk their lives to run around acting tough in a big mob psychology gang, but they would not risk their lives to fight tyranny. And in a way, I thought, well, at least they're out there risking their lives and being wild. I mean, at least they're not totally domesticated. So I was having a love-hate relationship in my thought process about these people. And my dad, Sunday, we went to dinner with the kids, after the radio show. And he's like, I wish you wouldn't talk about killing people on air. And I was just being honest that I was going into kill mode. I mean, and people say, well, that's radical. That's bad. I mean, these people shouldn't be menacing children. I mean, in the old days, folks, you would have gotten, dealt with for that. And as he drove off, almost killed himself, I was going to yell something, and I just didn't. Plus, he was already gone. I thought, well, that idiot will just kill himself. And I'm always seeing these signs about look for bikes, be nice to the motorcycles, be nice to the regular bike riders. And the bike riders are pulling out in front of you. The motorcycle people are pulling out in front of you. They drive through the middle of the lanes when you're in traffic, almost killing themselves. No, motorcycle riders need to get their act together. I mean, I'm tired of men bugging their eyes out at me. I'm tired. And the problem is so many times in my life, I'll go, okay, let's go ahead and have a fight then, punk. And then people back off. It's like, what did you want? You wanted to go ahead and start a fight with somebody? And then if they respond back, you back off because you weren't really looking for a fight. You were looking to act tough and have a fake victory over some coward. I mean, I just cannot believe how weak people are, how pathetic they are. I mean, if I ever got off on menacing children, I would never commit suicide, but I mean, I would go jump off a cliff. I mean, if I ever became someone who wanted to menace children and whoever wanted to have power over weak people and whoever wanted people at my mercy, I just don't understand it. I just cannot imagine people like that. I cannot even begin to understand it. But that's mob psychology. That's getting in a crazed mode. I mean, born in the Bilderbergs, I got in a crazed mode a few times. It felt really good. But I was in control of it. I knew that's what these instincts are for. It was meant to let them know we're aware of them, we're angry, we're upset with them. Word is Rockefeller didn't go, he's super ill. A bunch of big names didn't go. Bilderberg's almost dead politically. So big victory on that front. It's just that we're under such globalist assault. How do I get all these men that think it's manly to wear sports team hats and outfits? It's manly to ride a motorcycle. It's manly to stick their chest out at the swim meet and walk around with their big muscles. I mean, those big muscles are for defending women and children. They're not for strutting around acting tough like you're a rooster in a barnyard. Humans are supposed to be different. And the globalists, they are scientists. They study us like they're another species. They say that in their own words. And sit there punching our buttons. And absolutely gaming the 99% of people. I'm even gamed. I shouldn't be upset about Rand Paul and Ron Paul doing a political thing. They've been overall useful to liberty. You know, the fact that they've gotten so big and didn't use that to try to really keep having an effect, but kind of instead think they can take over the Republican Party, it's a miscalculation, but it doesn't matter. Compared to genetic engineering, world government, the drones, the police state, the checkpoints, it isn't about them. It shouldn't be about them. They could be killed, imprisoned, set up, destroyed. It's about an idea that all of us share for liberty that isn't going anywhere. So I handled the Ron Paul thing the way I handled it. It's not a mistake. It's not a victory. It's a process of working it out. And I never even got to this. I'll get to it later if I have time, where people are told, grow up and realize we've got to be political. We got to where we are because we compromise. Got big TSA news, big drone news. I'm going to get into the TSA news when we come back. Then I'm getting into drone news. Then I'm getting in carbon tax news.
For a long time, you've heard me talk about building your own food supply with eFoods Direct. As a listener, you know why you need to have a supply of the best storable food on the planet. Every day, we document the attempts to take control of our lives. But there's one thing we can all control, your greatest dependency, food. eFoods Direct products are made with only the best ingredients and none of the trash and contaminants like trans fats, GMOs, or MSG. This food is nutrient-dense and tastes great. It's simple to make, portable, and has a shelf life of up to 25 years. Now with eFoods Direct, you'll get the most affordable, best-tasting food you can buy. To celebrate the beginning of summer, you can save 20% off their already affordable prices. This offer ends on June 20th, so take advantage of the summer savings now. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex for specials. Don't let this offer pass you by. Call 800-409-5633. Or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. More the best for less, guaranteed.
In a coming apart world, you need something to keep it tied together. That something is Atwood Rope, the highest quality rope made in the USA from exotic braids for military, rescue, arborists, shipyards, towline, or boating. Quality rope at affordable prices you and your customers can depend on. Find a dealer or shop online at atwoodrope.net. Enter promo code RADIO to receive 100 feet of 550 paracord free with purchase. Atwood Rope, working to keep the world tied together.
OnlyBatteries.com is where to turn for all your battery needs. In stock, fresh, guaranteed, fast shipping, non-rechargeable batteries, rechargeable batteries, battery chargers, custom battery packs, all brand names for all the batteries you use at home, the office, the cottage, and the car. OnlyBatteries.com. Get 25% off using coupon code 7500. Call right now, 1-800-660-7705, or visit OnlyBatteries.com. OnlyBatteries.com. That's OnlyBatteries.com.
Now at DeseretFoodStore.com, sign up for a one-month supply of delicious food for only $99 with free shipping. That's right, only $99. Gourmet restaurant-style meals with a 30-year shelf life. Packaged in heavy-duty Mylar bags for easy transport and freshness. Meals like stroganoff, lasagna, teriyaki, five-bean chili, granola pancakes, and much more. Visit DeseretFoodStore.com, spelled D-E-S-E-R-E-T, FoodStore.com, or call 801-444-1444. Food for now, food for life.
37 things to hoard. Do you have the 37 crucial food items you can't survive without? When disaster hits and mobs go crazy grabbing food off the shelves, your family may be without food or waiting in long food lines. Prepare now at 123survivalplan.com. That's 123survivalplan.com. Many people don't have these 37 food items. Learn what you need to hoard now at 123survivalplan.com. Watch the video over 1 million people have viewed to discover the 37 food items that will sell out first when disaster strikes at 123survivalplan.com.
and the sun is going to burn into a cinder before we ever pass this way again. Turn this part up. It's great poetry by Willie Nelson. And we're going to ride.
And we're going to ride. We're going to ride.
You know who that is, right? That's Johnny Cash.
Ride like a one-eyed jack of diamonds.
Then coming up, Waylon Jennings. God bless his soul. Oh, I got to load both the Highwaymen up on my iPad or iPod. I never have time to listen to music. I don't even know if I have an iPad anymore. I have one of those little, whatever you call them, iPods. Barrel, barrel, barrel. That is some good stuff right there. I'm sorry. I'm just here ranting. I just want freedom. I know you want freedom. What do we do about it? How do we turn the tide against this total giant arms buildup takeover of our society by a bunch of criminals? This article is from Natural News. J.D. Hayes is up at Infowars.com. Congresswoman lashes out at TSA for hiring pedophiles and child pornographers. She first came out a few weeks ago. She's done it again. Never an agency that does much to clear its bad name and terrible reputation for hiring some of the worst dregs of society, all while failing regularly to live up to its purpose for existing. They're receiving fresh criticism from Tennessee Congresswoman over its hiring of pedophiles and child molesters. Yeah, every day or two I see articles about it. And an extremely critical report, Representative Marsha Blackburn, I want to get her on, by the way, guys, listed 50 crimes that have been committed by TSA agents. Well, there's a lot more than 50. And it goes on, just at the Nashville airport, they get into all the things they've been doing. And the thing is, they target congresspeople. Once they know you've criticized them, they try to hurt you physically. They go in, you know, Miss USA's pants. I mean, this is going on. And we have a clip of a woman who'd just been grabbed on, freaking out, calling police, but police came after her. You know, you're going to let people break the law, get out of their jurisdiction, they're not even police, do this to you, or you're going to go to jail. We're going to go in your pants. We're going to grab your breast. We're going to take your shirt off in front of people. We're going to take you in a back room and rip your colostomy bag off. Here it is, Daily Mail. She molested me. Somebody help me. Woman passenger cries for help at airport security after invasive search by female TSA agent. Yeah, what makes it okay that it's same sex? It's almost worse that it's, you know, men that want to touch on you. I mean, I don't care if you look like a supermodel. I don't want some woman I don't know touching on me. You know, I've grown past college days where, you know, just period, I was looking for women today. I mean, you know, it's a big deal. If I'm married, you know, it's a big deal. You know, this is for having children. This is not for you to get your jollies off on. In fact, let's go ahead and play some of this tape. Here it is, a familiar sound that we've learned to hear from these abusers.
I'm a police officer now. No, I'm a police officer.
Police officer, nobody's gonna help you, lady. Take a cancer shot. Drink some fluoride. Look at those TSA morons.
Somebody help me!
Nobody's going to help you, lady. Switchblade drones are coming. That's enough. I'm just glad that the Switchblade drones are coming and the Google admits they're NSA stealing your data codes illegally and the banks admit they bring in the drugs and they run the narcotics and they admit they want world government and they admit in Europe they're setting up checkpoints to take your bank accounts. Good. To quote Han Solo, I'd rather a straight-on fight than all this sneaking around. Oh, man. I mean, you know what? Let's just get it out in the open. And coming up, another drone crashes, and they announce the Switchblades are coming. Little attack killer drones for you and your family. Paid for by you and your family. But the illegal aliens are above the law. We'll be right back.
This is GCN, the Genesis Communications Radio Network.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at Infowars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require acquire electricity, purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
All right, Jesse Ventura is coming up in the next hour. We'll open the phones up coming up here in a little while as well. I need to get into transhumanism and a bunch of other articles I haven't broken down yet. We'll cover drones in the start of the next segment. Coming up at the bottom of the hour, I will get to this. I said I would yesterday and never did. United Nations envisions transhumanist future where man is obsolete. We're going to play this video and critique it, and I'm going to break down each part of it as we go through it. And then later I'm going to put together a whole presentation out of this with clips from Endgame. But the UN says end of humanity as we know it. This is just the set plan, and they're going to wreck our genetics so bad we're going to have to go to government and corporations to even be able to have children, and then they'll be designer with back doors built into all of them. By the way, will you print me that Business Insider article about the Pentagon saying the Chinese government has had all their industries build back doors into all the tech we've bought from there? They didn't do that. They're part of the globalist program. That's agreed, standardized, so all the globalists have back doors into everything. And then re-pull me that article about Gattaca. Gattaca becomes reality, 3,500 traits, children to be killed for embryonically. If not, it's in last night's stack. I covered it on the nightly news last night. I just want to have that ready for the bottom of the hour. Incredible job. Actually, here is the Pentagon article. You did already have that ready for me. So we're going to be going over all of that at the bottom of the hour. Again, the magnitude of what's been announced in Associated Press, Financial Times of London, you name it, the criminal unelected EU bureaucracy that's made itself exempt from taxation says movement of money, people can be limited. The checkpoints are to allow foreigners in, but slaves of Europe are not allowed to get out. And they've prepared currency controls, capital controls. Here in the U.S., the TSA and its armored pillboxes are to command that. And that's when the Civil War is going to start. I'm not looking forward to it, but people trying to get out of Dodge, get to their little ranch or whatever, they pull up and the pedos want to rob the vehicle and maybe take your kids to a re-education camp, which they admit they have. That's when it's going to be, what do they call it, rock and roll? Rock and roll. And they got armored pillboxes with 50 cals they're going to open up on you and your family. And they're going to send in some switchblade drones. Hoorah against the American people. Score one for Goldman Sachs. Ha, 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 ha. Yeah. Rout the slaves with little buck-toothed, snot-nosed 20-year-olds, you know, at Homeland Security flying the drones 1,000 miles away. I got 2 kills today, boss. I killed Patriots. you know, that's exactly how these people operate. There it is, Pentagon, to soon deploy pint-sized but lethal switchblade drones. Ah. Against the... Guys, people won't believe it. Will you print me Texas police want armed drones, and turns out a bunch have already bought them? And at first, it'll just be pepper spray and rubber bullets they've announced. But then nerve gas, shotguns, mini missiles, 50 cals. Oh, it's so lavish. By the way, we thought about actually getting one, but I thought it was too dangerous for the video shoot we did. We actually have catalogs where you can buy drones yourself that have guns mounted to them. And again, it's all so cowards in government can start a civil war and launch drones and combat UGVs on us. Hey, folks, people aren't going to run out and face the UGVs, and no amount of checkpoints is going to save you. If you go to this physical globalist takeover, people are going to come find you in your homes, at your bars, your churches, and your restaurants. You cannot stop people once the vendettas begin. You go in the bathroom at church, somebody's waiting in there with an ice pick. I don't want this civil war to start, but folks, if they do start it, start trying to round everybody up, we've got the initiative, we've got the power, 50,000 drones, 100,000, it means nothing. We will not face them on their turf. We will strike when we want to strike in the info war and beyond, defending the republic from foreign globalist occupiers.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup insurance and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
For a long time, you've heard me talk about building your own food supply with eFoods Direct. As a listener, you know why you need to have a supply of the best storable food on the planet. Every day, we document the attempts to take control of our lives. But there's one thing we can all control, your greatest dependency, food. eFoods Direct products are made with only the best ingredients and none of the trash and contaminants like trans fats, GMOs, or MSG. This food is nutrient dense and tastes great. It's simple to make, portable, and has a shelf life of up to 25 years. Now with eFoods Direct, you'll get the most affordable, best-tasting food you can buy. And the new products and pricing will blow you away. Compared to other food sources, including home-cooked meals, you can cut your food cost in half. You just can't afford to ignore this. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex for specials. Don't let this offer pass you by. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. More the best for less, guaranteed.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Former Minnesota Governor Jesse Ventura is going to be joining us and breaking some big news. Be sure and stay with us. That's in about 52 minutes from now. At the bottom of the hour, I said I'd get to this yesterday. I just ran out of time. I will get into United Nations envisions transhumanist future where man is obsolete. Now I'm going to play highlights from the UN conference here and stop it and start it and analyze it. So that is coming up. At the bottom of the hour, a key report to understand how the globalists think and the world they think they're building. See, all the tech has back doors in it designed to not empower humanity, but absolutely dumb you down and enslave you. So the big secrets of the transhumanist leadership, Does that mean that anyone that talks about augmenting humanity through technology is bad? No, it's not a judgment on that issue itself, but you need to know Aldous Huxley's brother, Julian Huxley, the head of UNESCO at the UN, said Hitler made eugenics look bad, and he founded the transhumanist in the late 1940s. So it is an offshoot of the globalists trying to become godmen. I'm not the one saying that. When I broke that down in Endgame, big publications over and over again say Jones believes all this stuff's going to happen. No, I'm not the one saying this. My film reports on what they're saying and doing with the quotes, with the articles, with the video clips. And they are madmen. But our entire society is governed by this. You can talk about a few countries in Africa, Middle East, that haven't adopted the globalist program. The globalist program is so advanced in every case, so far ahead. It's a lie that the West is only thinking quarterly. They get us in the false paradigm politically that we follow via the media template to live in a quarterly mindset so that we're not long-term thinkers. But when you hear the Chinese or 25-year thinkers and the Japanese, folks, the globalists, and Brzezinski's written about this, are thinking in 100-year, 50-year, and 25-year plans. Okay? That's why they created the internet. That's why they discovered DNA. Look it up. Everything. Biometrics, 150 years old. Eugenics. Genome. Eugenics. All of them were eugenicists because the robber barons over 150 years ago in Europe, England, and the United States funded only scientific research along those lines and would blackball, target, and even kill scientists that didn't play ball. And it wasn't just with genetics. It was with technologies like electricity. They shut down Tesla. That's on record, raided him, made everybody adopt the other systems. We live in a society they built. And I played you a clip from the precursor of Charlie Rose's show with that Hefner character on there with the authors of The Wise Men back in the 80s, admitting these were the guys that built our modern world. Carol Quigley says that. And so people say, well, go ahead and let them rule. They built the world. They built what we live in. They want us dead. They're getting down towards the final end game. And they've made a lot of mistakes. It's just that they were able to take over because they were ruthless. All right, I'm already getting into this news. The point is, okay, let's say some of you elitists that follow these guys want to be elitists. You say, well, they're in control. Why not, you know, let them have control? Obviously, they got control. That's social Darwinistic garbage. And again, I'm not debating Darwinism one way or the other. The social Darwinism, this idea that if you can get away with something, do it. That is very, very destructive. And the point is the globalists are going to destroy themselves. But that's coming up. Let me get into drones right now. Again, I told you more than 15 years ago that there was a plan to fully convert the entire Pentagon system, Air Force, Army, Marines, Navy, to the entire helicopter, fixed-wing aircraft system, 100% to drone, with only some troop transports themselves that are computer flown on autopilot with humans basically as like toilet attendants. The New World Order wants abject programming in humans. That's what shaving the head, brainwashing, the whole military training developed by the Prussians 300 years ago that took over military training. It's all about making you follow orders like a machine. Well, the Pentagon, top futurists like Mr. Marshall at the Pentagon, they've all said humans are done. How did I know all this 14, 15 years ago? Because I was reading their own documents on air. But this was more academic at the time. It was not widely publicized. People said, Jones is crazy. You can pull these up. Jones says we're going to face combat ground robots. Jones says the entire military force will be drones, and they're going to be domestically. Jones says there's already giant blimps at 100,000 feet or more with ground-penetrating radar looking through our walls. It was Pentagon budget. I mean, it was in there, just nobody wanted to talk about it. Jones says they can park these blimps up there and microwave you slowly in your house. You don't know why you die of cancer. That's a Pentagon admission. Jones says they're weaponizing dolphins. Jones is crazy. What's he think? This is Buck Rogers? Well, yeah, Buck Rogers came out in the 20s, folks. It's 2012. Back then it was, you know, 2000, 1998. Everything you see in the Matrix movie is in a Pentagon plan they published in 2000 that was declassified from the 70s. Does that mean they're going to actually do that? All I know is everything they wanted to do, they're a little bit behind, but they've gotten exactly what they would say. And you see, soon you're going to have total interfaces with computers. You'll be able to have unlimited pleasure centers. Philip K. Dick called these wireheads. And people will want, and they're going to say it's for the environment, they're to be in these pods. And they've got movies out. I saw it. I forget the one with Bruce Willis where, you know, he's like this old, you know, dirty, unhealthy, debilitated guy who's got atrophied muscle. It's called Surrogates. And but then he's got his handsome young body out there walking around. That's a Pentagon plan. And the UN came out and announced all of that in this video that's coming up. I'm already getting into it, as you notice. So I watch with horror as they build this thing. And Ray Kurzweil doesn't tell you. They don't tell you at this UN meeting where it's all happy and lovey and it's going to be utopia like Zeitgeist. We all live in the plastic cities together. That long before this is implemented, they plan to release giant bio attacks to be blamed on private groups, to then have giant police state crackdowns, and the next bio attack will be an order of magnitude bigger, and they plan to kill almost everyone. And that's all stated, too, in hundreds and hundreds of documents, but then that's why you see it in movies and culture. They're getting you ready, and they have Discovery and History Channel shows about the end of humans and how wonderful it will be and how the nature will come back. And because they're preparing you with a self-fulfilling prophecy to accept the end. And all the globalists talk about is how they hate the malls and the water parks and ugly humanity. And then they give you propaganda so you act in an ugly way to make you the losers they say you are. And they plan to kill almost everyone listening to this show right now. And so I'm ashamed of myself caring about Ron Paul and Rand Paul beginning to waffle some. You know what? They're allies for basic liberty, Second Amendment, stuff like that. But they're informed. Ron Paul knew HIV was a weapon two decades ago and has been criticized for it. Ron Paul knows everything I know and more at many levels. And he doesn't think the public's ready to hear that. And he thinks he's going to work with the system. He's wrong. But Ron Paul is not our enemy. Ron Paul is our friend. And it doesn't even matter. Look, everything is about getting people to realize that we're being inserted into an artificial habitat in the globalist own words, and that more and more they're getting the global government they want and the total micromanaged system, and that we've got to shake people out of their trance. And I've been thinking this for a long time. I've thought about radical departures from what I do here on air and starting a foundation for the continuation of the human species, the Human Preservation Foundation, something along those lines, and really getting coteries of people that understand this and creating cell groups, public cell groups, that are aware, that educate and prepare people, because it's going to be bad, okay? And it's really going to unseat the system that I've spent time studying their master plan, that even most of their top minions are deluded and are compartmentalized because they're lazy. They could learn all this, that if we can actually create a 3D model of this and put it in cyberspace of the master plan, if we do it soon enough, it will be so devastating as it all unfolds that people will see it as prophecy. It isn't prophecy. And then they will finally listen. And so I've been spinning my wheels, wasting my time, and I've known this. I've known this. I mean, look, I can't even go on air and goof around and have fun anymore or cover this news item or that or plant hooks for the radio audience. And even I don't even plug sponsors hardly anymore to even fund our operation, because it's just all window dressing, I realize. I am fully beginning to break the matrix in my own mind and getting a clearer image of all this. And we've got to show people it's a mass illusion. I mean, look, I told you about all this, not because I'm smart. It's all an admitted plan. Navy drone crashes off Maryland. No injuries. Just getting everybody ready for that. Find out how your local police agency is using drones, including Predators. Electronic Frontier Foundation. U.S. drone crashes in Maryland. Already covered that. We've got a report out here. Again, we'll put it up on screen, where they've got these new pint-sized drones, Los Angeles Times. Pentagon to soon deploy pint-sized but lethal switchblade drones. And that's what I explained in the video we shot, drones shot down over Texas, was that the system... Yeah, click on the LA Times, then see the photo of it, please. The blue link right there, thank you. If you're watching at PrisonPlanet.tv. The system knows that we're waking up to all this, so they're just rapid deploying it. That's why we shot down pint-sized drones, because that's what we're mainly going to be facing. Giant assembly lines not making slave goods anymore for Walmart.
Survival is not about the end of the world. It's not about a hypothetical plane crash or the latest violent storm. Survival is about the satisfaction of knowing you can take care of yourself and your family in any situation, anytime, anywhere. CampingSurvival.com was started in 1956. No, not the .com part, the survival part. CampingSurvival.com has over 17,000 urban, wilderness, and preparedness items. Supreme customer service, very low shipping, and no games. We look around to make sure we have the lowest prices, and CampingSurvival.com is 100% USMC veteran owned. Don't base your survival on the latest spring up on the internet company. Do business with an authority on survival. CampingSurvival.com. Use coupon code GCN at checkout, and CampingSurvival.com will take 5% off your order. CampingSurvival.com. Confidence born of preparation.
Emergency Essentials has Mountain House deals in June. Going on now, Emergency Essentials, the 24-year leader in emergency preparedness supplies, does it again with up to 25% off Mountain House foods. Don't miss these savings. All Mountain House number 10 cans are 20 to 25% off during the month of June only at BePrepared.com. Mountain House foods have superior taste and a scientifically proven 25-year shelf life because they start with fresh or frozen foods, then cook, prepare, and finally freeze dry them. All the goodness, flavor, and taste are locked in as if handmade from scratch. Mountain House, the same great meals enjoyed by campers and outdoorsmen the world over. Hurry now through June 30th. Call 800-999-1863 to experience exceptional customer service and the BePrepared.com low price guarantee. That's 800-999-1863. The choice is clear. Be unprepared or BePrepared.com.
In a coming apart world, you need something to keep it tied together. That something is Atwood Rope, the highest quality rope made in the USA from exotic braids for military, rescue, arborists, shipyards, towline, or boating. Quality rope at affordable prices you and your customers can depend on. Find a dealer or shop online at atwoodrope.net. Enter promo code RADIO to receive 100 feet of 550 paracord free with purchase. Atwood Rope, working to keep the world tied together.
Only Batteries.com is where to turn for all your battery needs. In stock, fresh, guaranteed, fast shipping, non-rechargeable batteries, rechargeable batteries, battery chargers, custom battery packs, all brand names for all the batteries you use at home, the office, the cottage, and the car. Only Batteries.com. Get 25% off using coupon code 7500. Call right now, 1-800-660-7705, or visit OnlyBatteries.com. OnlyBatteries.com. That's OnlyBatteries.com.
Hello, this is Ty Bollinger, author of the best-selling book, Cancer, Step Outside the Box. I want you to know some very important information. In 1985, President Ronald Reagan requested that Carnivora be sent directly to the White House at a time when only the president could obtain this world-class healer. Now, 27 years later, Carnivora capsules are used around the world to keep people healthy. Now you can protect yourself and your loved ones in this age of superbugs with 17 naturally occurring compounds that instinctively respond to abnormal cells only without harming a single normal cell. If you want to stay healthy, now's your chance to literally wake up your critical immune cells to attack harmful invaders that don't belong in your body. Call 1-866-VENUS-FLY or order from carnivora.com. That's carnivora.com. That's 1-866-836-8735, 1-866-VENUS-FLY, or visit carnivora.com. Protect your immune system. It's the only one you've got.
Because we can sit here and chronicle power-mad people at every level going wild and the coordinated implosion of economies, deindustrialization, all the admitted plans, the admissions of GMO designed to reduce our fertility until we've got to go to the system to be reactivated. They're not going to ask you. They're just doing it. All of this is already so deep into the plan that people walk over to me at swim meets and things and want to talk about sports and stuff, and I just like look at them like they're a pygmy trying to tell me about the booga booga, you know, dragon or something that they say sneaks around in the woods. I mean, it's like talking to mental midgets. And I'm not on a power trip. I've just learned that the elites think of everybody as absolute garbage. They have fooled people through psychology and process. They're experts. I mean, a great example of this is Rand Paul endorsing Mitt Romney. The system knows, and the Rand Paul people understand, that the public is buying into the delusion that, well, Obama's been bad, so let's go for Mitt Romney, and then Romney will be bad, so let's go for this guy. And so they're like, hey, the public doesn't quite buy what we're saying. They're going to get mad at us if we don't endorse Romney. We want to do this. But it really is rearranging deck chairs on the Titanic. The real power that the Pauls would have had was to really call out this system and be called kooks. The Pauls should know they really won early states, that they really were getting the most grassroots donations, that they were winning the info war. And the direction they're taking is one that I'm sure will give them success within the political process, but it's a political process that's fake. It doesn't go above Mitt Romney and Barack Obama. There's a ceiling to this. And you don't even break out into the real atmosphere of what's happening in real politics until you break out of that. And I'm not a spectator. I know our listeners aren't spectators. I mean, human potential is about really learning how things work. And this is like a giant Truman Show or The Matrix or the analogy of the little man behind the curtain and the great wondrous Oz. I've been behind the curtain and people want to keep saying, no, no, it's real. And I'm like, no, it's not. No, it's not. You know, Ron Paul was real because the whole system came out against him and lied about him and said he couldn't win because he was anti-Patriot Act, anti-torture, anti all these wars, pro-constitution, anti-globalist bankster. He was exposing corporate welfare. He was anathema. And now, yeah, Rand Paul talked bad about the nanny state and, hey, let the Amish have their milk. Okay, great. That's little stuff where there's not that big of a lobby against him. But where there's a big pro-war lobby, he's starting to bend to it. And don't you understand, just like a third world country, the pro-war lobby is eating America now. The Defense Department says they're going to have troops on every street and they're going to have local reaction forces and let the police call in airstrikes. That was announced by a sitting U.S. general in a CFR report 2 weeks ago. When we were on the road, we covered it. All of this was acclimation. We've been under psych warfare. They'd say, we're not going to be on the streets. This is just a drill. And it was always for a takeover. We got footage 14 years ago of the military training, the Army and Marines in Maryland and California and Texas to go door to door with the Boy Scouts telling if their parents had guns. We got it on tape. It's in Police State 2000. And then 3 years ago, it's in the New York Times. And people were still calling us going, it can't be true. I love the Boy Scouts. It's not that the Boy Scouts are bad. Be like if your daughter got raped. She's not bad. She's been taken over. These are children that have been taken over via treason. You should be saying no. And there they are in the New York Times training to take on disgruntled veterans who won't turn their guns in. I mean, I found out every ROTC in the country. You know what drill they do at colleges when they go on maneuvers? The Young Officer Corps, in the making, they train to take on U.S. militias and get FEMA briefings bad-mouthing George Washington. If you don't believe me and have family in ROTC, ask them. And watch them at the dinner table tell you it's classified. And get off on it. These are young people getting off on, wait a minute, you know that? That's classified. I can't talk to you about domestic plans to take on the American people. That's when you grab your 20-year-old son around the neck and say, listen here, Junior, that's treason. You better well tell me about it right now, punk. Or just go outside. You think you're so tough, mister. These are the discussions that have to be happening right now. Right now. Right now. They've hired every stinking preacher I know of in this country as the clergy response teams, getting everybody ready for martial law. They didn't make all these preparations for nothing. They plan on pulling the trigger.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at InfoWars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. InfoWars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at InfoWars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds could become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that it could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for SurvivalSeedBank.com.
The globalists hate nationalism, but they will use its name to sell their tyranny. They play all the major angles. We, as liberty lovers, have to play on truth and on self-preservation and tell the minions of the system that you're going to be destroyed, guaranteed going along with this. And a lot of you aren't going to listen now, but you better remember and make the right decision later. I'm going to get into the big transhumanist report here in a moment, and then Jesse Ventura is coming up, and we'll probably open the phones up for Ventura when he is on with us. A lot of other news I'm going to be going over that we'll cover after I cover the transhumanist news. First off, if you go to Infowars.com, if you'd like to financially support this radio/TV transmission, the nightly news, everything we do, we have great products that I believe in and use, discounted at the lowest prices you'll find anywhere. Take ProPure, the best gravity-fed stainless steel filters out there, side-by-side comparison to the leading competitor at InfowarsShop.com or InfowarsStore.com. We'll get you there. There's no comparison. Go look at it for yourself. Watch the video presentation that I go over. We already have the lowest price, 10% off on top of that when you use the promo code WATER at checkout. And I did a lot of studying as I continue my preparedness, not because I'm living in fear. I'm living prepared. We have these at the lowest prices you're going to find, and a free citizen rule book and InfoWars bumper stickers. The Life Straw, you can drink swamp water with this, and it makes it safe to drink. Cuts out all the bacteria, viruses, stuff like that. It does not obviously get rid of fluoride. It's a chemical weapon and so small that almost nothing stops it. We've got some chemical filters that you can get with the ProPure that'll actually reduce it almost down to nothing, but it binds to the aluminum. It's an aluminum filter. People say, well, then we get aluminum. No, it binds to it, you know, just like in chemistry. The point is Life Straw, excellent product, and it is available discounted with Citizen Rulebook at Infowars.com. And I got these and was so impressed with them going on hikes and stuff. That's the one thing I've still got time to do. That, I mean, I've stuck this right into, you know, rain puddles and just slurped it up. Absolutely delicious. Works so well. There's a promo video there at the site as well, Infowars.com. So it's a win-win-win. Get great prices on products that everybody needs and will certainly enjoy and use. And get great prices on it and support the broadcast, Infowars.com. Just click on the shopping link at the top or go to InfowarsShop.com or InfowarsStore.com. We'll take you to the same place, the Infowars Shop, InfowarsShop.com or 888-253-3139. That's 888-253-3139. And we have Jesse Ventura's great new book, Democrips and Reblublicans, 1995, just came out yesterday, hardcover, normally $24.95. And we've got, you can get American Conspiracies, an excellent book, and 63 Documents the Government Doesn't Want You to Know About, each of those for $4.95 a piece. So all three books for $29 and change, or just get Democrips and Reblublicans at the discounted price there at Infowars.com. And lastly, all my books, videos, other great videos like A Noble Lie, they're all available at Infowars.com. Films like Police State 2000, showing the Marines training with the Boy Scouts to go tell them what mommy and daddy are doing. I mean, it's wild. This has all been going on behind the scenes. When do we know they're getting ready to strike? When they roll it out publicly. Because they've got to then do the PSYOP to acclimate. And they're trying to get the military to go along with it. Everybody's getting psyoped here. The police are getting psyoped. We're getting psyoped as the citizens. And we're all Americans. And by the way, if you live in Australia, Canada, Israel, Germany, it doesn't matter. Governments use whatever the latest psyops are. And the big corporations that control them do. So it's the same systems. Our police are wearing black masks and raiding political people. The Russians are wearing black masks and doing it. The Russians are chemtrailing, our criminal government's chemtrailing, because it's the same type of psychopaths running things everywhere. The Russians are involved in the New World Order, so are the Chi-Coms, but they're different gangs using the same management system, but they go to war with each other as well. They're now reporting that attack helicopters are being sent from Russia to Syria. I mean, this thing is escalating fast. The U.S. is using, the so-called U.S., to get the country back. We've got to admit that it was taken. They're sending in al-Qaeda forces. Some people are like, well, don't side with Russia, side with al-Qaeda. You know what? I'm going to be against the initiation of force and starting a war so the globalists can wreck Syria and make it even more backward than it already has been through sanctions and things. Once an industrialized society. This is the globalist with our money and our name initiating guerrilla warfare attacks, now wanting bombardments. And I see emails and comments going, oh, Alex, imminent war in Syria, just like everywhere else. Yeah, it is imminent using guerrilla forces and asymmetrical, and now they're on the news wanting bombardment from the air, calling them peace bombs. Libya was a war. So don't ask me to buy into your delusional world where they don't call it a war. So, hey, Alex, where's the Libya war? Thought it was coming. And I'm like, is that a joke? It was a giant war. 50-something thousand killed, 40,000 of them ethnically cleansed, hundreds of thousands run out of the country, Arab al-Qaeda brought in to do it, bombardment all over the country, and you're sitting there saying there wasn't a war. I mean, it's like this alternate dimension where delusional camp followers of the Matrix system look at you like there's something wrong with you because you're informed. It's like an idiocracy where he's before the judge and he's actually defending himself and can actually speak. And the judge is like, oh, he's gay. He's retarded. He's, look, he can talk. Oh, funny talk. I've actually had people before when I've been in public on vacation reading a book coming over going, hey, the Cowboy game's on. What you doing reading a book? And you just look at them because they can't believe a man is outside by the pool, you know, at some hotel reading a book with his children swimming instead of watching a football game. And it's because, listen, I live in the real world, not in a little world where the men slap each other on the hind end and do all the little stuff. And that's what's manly. And guys walk out with their case of beer and act real tough to their car to go see a football game. Yeah. You know, yeah, and Sandusky grabbing little kids and the TSA and everything. I'm not criticizing if you like football. I can go to a football game and get into it. It's like an anthropology experiment and go, yes, here are the primitives, little event programmed for them. There's the Defense Department propaganda during all the breaks. When they make a touchdown, they'll cut to military clapping in a Pavlovian way to associate, victory in touchdowns with the U.S. military. You know, they make the dunk of the basketball, cut to military. They make the field goal, cut to military. And I just sit there watching everyone being bombarded with a Pentagon set flicker rate to put them into a catatonic state near dream state. And I mean, I'm just like, oh, it's real fun. Yeah, it's fun. It's real fun to be under a psych warfare attack. Oh, yeah. So, and some will say, oh, stop being so uppity. I'm not uppity. I'm just a regular guy who saw the other side of it. And I'm like, hey, folks, this is all a big illusion. It's like Plato's cave. They're all down in the cave, chained up, watching a fire behind them with puppeteers doing a puppet show. And they think what's projected on the cave wall, just like television. Man, Plato was smart. Also had to be a eugenicist. That's kind of the problem. He's their grand guru. And they said, oh, yeah, Plato, we're going to actually create a physical. And later I saw this and looked it up knowing I would actually find articles about where the globalists did create it. And I found some of their own literature where they liken the television to Plato's cave wall. I mean, these people know what they're doing. And they're all looking at the cave wall. Well, one of the guys who's chained up finally is able to break out, and he looks up and sees sunlight up there, and he goes out and sees deer and fish in the brook and the sun and the moon, and it's so incredible, and he goes back to them, and they make fun of him and say, look, he's not trendy. He's imagining stuff. We're really good at interpreting the stuff we see on the cave wall dancing in front of us, you know, like putting your hand in front of a projector when you were a kid doing a duck or a dinosaur, and they're all really good at the little controlled matrix paradigm and laughing at you. And he says, okay, I just wanted to help you and show you there's something much bigger. And they say, we don't want your help, pal. We want to go back in the matrix. And I mean, so I try to reach people in the matrix by even going along with the Ron Paul thing. And I realize that doesn't help them. You want to reach in, and that's a sellout too. That's a smaller thing than what the Pauls did, but even playing games with any of this, I realize more and more, is addressing and going, okay, I won't talk about the outside big world out there. You're making a little duck on the wall there. Yes. Yes. Oh, look at that. A tiger just came out. Oh, yes. Oh, there's this whole universe outside the cave, and you're not going to get them. You're not going to get them that way. People say you've got to be easy with people. You've got to be, you know, slow with it. No, it's all a big stinking illusion. Well, how do you know the government's evil? Look up chemical, biological, radiological testing on foster children, black people, U.S. troops. Back to the 20s, they were killing our troops in secret experiments to create cadres of scientists who were compromised and who would do anything. Most of them well-meaning in a sick way, believing it was in justifies the means, kill a few hundred to save a few million. But those running it were really doing it because they have disdain for everyone and want to kill the mass of society. All right, let's get into the big report. And I've already been leading up to this here, so this whole, in the last 20 minutes really just integrates in with this information. United Nations envisions transhumanist future where man is obsolete. And that's Aaron Dyke's article at Infowars.com. The Globalist Future 2045 International Congress, led by iconic futurist Ray Kurzweil, who says he wants world government, and held in Moscow a few months back, lays out stark vision of a future for neo-human where AI, cybernetics, nanotech, and other emerging technologies replace mankind, and openly transhumanist visions now being steered by the elite, which emerge out of a Darwinistic circles directed by the likes of T.H. Huxley and his grandchildren, Julian, who coined the term transhumanism. As Aldous Huxley, author of Brave New World, resistance to this rapid shift in society, the 2045 conference argues, is nothing short of return to the Middle Ages. Now let's stop there. They frame the whole thing as if it's a foregone conclusion. They're offering you this heaven-like Valhalla that is a foregone conclusion that your brain will be transplanted in a machine and copies of it will be distributed out and death will be conquered and all of this is going to be wonderful, led by Ray Kurzweil, who says he's going to reanimate his father with the technology because he has a bunch of his father's belongings. Ain't going to happen, pal. And that he's going to live forever and eat something like 200 pills a day. Vitamins. That's very similar to the longevity program, but you're not going to live forever on that, pal. But the point is that Kurzweil, and he's got all these elitists and Hollywood stars bought into it on his program, William Shatner, the list goes on and on, and they go to this conference and it's all global government, except nanotech, except wirehead, except interfaces, everything's fine. They don't tell you this is all Department of Defense 1950s, 60s, 70s, 80s, DARPA. They don't know it's 1855 Sir Francis Galton envisioning biometric computer systems, overlays. I mean, like he was, you know, almost like he was channeling, you know, an off-world engineer from Prometheus. I mean, these people, they are smart. Come up with all this, the entire science, first computers, Hollerith machines, race mixing study, integrated systems, all of our modern technologies created by eugenicists or farmed out by scientists owned by eugenicist robber barons, the entire society, the whole technotronic plan, robotics, future not needing us, phasing out humanity, all of this, a hellish future, while they've been poisoning us and dumbing us down so we can't resist their takeover. And then saying we deserve it because all we want to do is watch Dancing with the Stars and Tebow and all the rest of it. I mean, this is amazing. And then I look at the mistakes they've made. They've been able to dominate things through sheer cancerous will. But that's like cancer taking over the body. It's not a win. And I think about how Galton and four other families, the Wedgwoods, the Huxleys, the Darwins, others, all married. And after three generations, almost all the children were stillborn, totally mentally retarded, or stark raving mad. The few that did survive were super intelligent, but extremely anti-human, because they interbred all of that anti-human, you know, garbage, to this super breed of egg-headed, toddling, crazy people like Huxley, who wrote in 32 the whole plan for world government, shrinking humans down through carbon taxes, genetic engineering, wrecking humans' genetics at first to then make them go to the medical tyranny, who would then backdoor the genetics and control and create a suboid group of humans to serve them if the technocrats don't decide to just kill us all and have robot androids serve them. Now, again, this is 1932. You can see he then said in 62, before dying, this was actually a plan to take over and told the Berkeley students that they were so stupid they couldn't even understand him. Well, I understood your speech, buddy pal, okay? So you guys do not deserve to take over humanity, and you say we're scum, I say we're not. I'm going to put out what you're doing and try to get the emergency transmission out. I mean, this is a worldwide global emergency transmission, what you're hearing. This is what's really going on, not all the other window dressing meant to distract you. And either we resist this and speak out against this, or they're going to carry out the next phases of their plan. The only way they'll talk to us is if we cut through all the garbage, really address them, confront them everywhere. everywhere and say, we're alive, we're sentient, we're human, we're not unconscious, we know what you're doing, and here's the problems with it, and we don't like it, and we're going to make sure when you try to carry this plan out that we have already exposed it so you don't get away with it. And it's the only hope we've got is the truth, that you will know the truth, the truth will set you free. We're going to skip this network break because I've got to get to this video. Network break, stations should not go over these. Okay, again, I not only don't do my on-air plugs, I don't even do the ads anymore. This info is so important. Okay, we're going to skip this break coming up in a minute. Let's start going to this video. This is what they put out to promote it. It happened a few months ago. Aaron pointed it out to me. They're always having these conferences, but this is with the Russian government. The UN sponsored it. And they just say, it's a foregone conclusion. No more families. No more what we were. This is what we're going to be. Well, you know what? And they say, oh, if the Amish don't want to do it, it won't matter. They'll be assimilated one way or the other. So in the final equation, they'll let you live in little reservations if you don't want to be part of this. But in the final equation, they say that they're just going to make you be assimilated. It's the Borg. Well, let me explain something. It isn't happening. I've seen what you people make, and it's ugly. You're cancer. Just being able to take over is not the proof that you should rule everything. So here is the sickening promo, and we're going to be stopping this throughout when I give the hand signals. I don't want to just be audibly cutting it off. I'm going to be making quick comments throughout it. This is what they say the future is, and that this is the only good future is this future, but all of it really has globalist backdoors in it, and it's meant to enslave you and get you addicted to computers, stimulating your pleasure centers, so you'll be happily turned off. That's the real plan. Here it is. 2045.
The world is on the verge of global change.
Engineered by you.
The speed of data transmission has increased by multiples of millions. The rate of globally significant events and that of discoveries and crises is growing.
Yeah, you've suppressed most of the real discoveries.
Our civilization is like an uncaptained ship sailing on rough seas.
No, the globalists are captaining it.
All the while moving faster and faster. The time we have to make the right decisions is shorter and shorter. We are facing the choice to fall into a new dark age, into affliction and degradation, or to find a new model for...
Head pause, back it up. What do I call it, the new dark age? Because they call it that. They want a transhumanist new dark age for the rest of us, turning off our resources in a post-industrial world, while in high-tech reservations, the new class system, they have the advanced tech, which people beg for like a slave-made iPad, like a slave-created iPad, made at slave factories with suicide nets, then they give it to the so-called upper class, and that itself is a weaponized system. Continue.
Dark Age, into affliction and degradation, or to find a new model for human development and create not simply a new civilization, but a new mankind.
Oh, their model.
Historic crises show that to break the deadlock, we need technological revolution. It is clear that today's revolution will also require the deepest social transformation.
Oh, yes.
The world's community and leaders should encourage
mankind. Oh, the UN.
Instead of wasting resources on solving momentary problems. To focus on the technologies of the future. Nanotechnology. Biotechnology. Information technology. Cognitive technology. Genetics and robotics.
Stop there.
Doing so.
No need to back it up. Again. And it's true we should focus on the big issues and not all the little petty fake ones, but they always offer the solution. Oh, their propaganda systems got you distracted, but here's our template. Go with our model, accept the GMO, all of it, with GMO from day one, with all sorts of poisons and sterilants engineered into it on purpose. So see, everything they're going to shovel is meant to destroy you, then they test it on you, and they use what's good for themselves. Here it is.
Will allow us to find new sources of energy.
Globalists block those.
Create new architecture and transportation. Allow unprecedented developments of human cognitive abilities.
Yeah.
Refine artificial intelligences and brain-computer interfaces. Simulate complex systems. Create humanoid robots and cyborgs. And with the help of nanorobots, we may develop manageable matter. Find ways to transfer one's personality to an artificial carrier. Yet what we need is not just another technological revolution, but a new civilizational paradigm. We need new philosophy and ideology, new ethics, new culture and new psychology, and even new metaphysics. We must reset our limits, go beyond ourselves, beyond the Earth, and beyond the solar system.
All right, stop again. They, through the educational system, wreck paradigms, make them tiny, and then give four-year-old level, oh, it's magic, come to us. And then they get into the religion that will guide it, the global religion that's anti-human, fake environmentalism. This is pure liquid death. Continue.
This is an adequate response to the challenges of our time. Thus, new reality and future man will arise. Could it happen spontaneously, by itself? Unlikely. Humanity does not have a master plan of its
own. Pause again.
It's
humanity doesn't have a master plan. Humanity's dumb, but they, the globalists, have a master plan. Yeah, we've been on it for a long time. Oh, Europe's falling apart. Oh, bankers will take over. They engineered it. We told you how they did it. It's on record they did it. Now they're going to be your saviors again. They're going to wreck our genetics with the GMO and the chemicals they already have. Now we have to go to them for the designer babies. Continue.
Seek stability. It lives in the present and does not plan. It preserves the status quo and tries to escape development. It does not tend to map future centuries and take responsibility for evil.
These transhumanists all say they're going to block our general development and only give us tech that controls us. Again, they oppose themselves for full spectrum dominance. Continue.
Evolution. In consumer society's culture, there is no evolutionary vocabulary and rhetoric. To break the deadlock, the Russia 2045 movement was founded. It is a mega project intended to reach new heights and meanings. We intend to create a new vector for civilization, aimed at constant human development and evolution. As happened with the mega projects of the last century, the nuclear and the space programs, we integrate the latest discoveries and developments.
All right, let's stop there. Yeah, the space program was a front for the secret program. Again, that's what all this is. It's about controlling technological development and then implying that they're basically the gods. And again, the UN sponsored this and that they have all the answers. And that you should just give in to having your humanity ended and merge with machines they make. They make. Remember that. With their back doors. Continue.
Energetics, aeronautics, bioengineering, nanotechnology, neurology, cybernetics, cognitive science. May everlasting spiritual ideals and values help us avoid going astray. Our project will give new meanings to the millions of people on Earth, will become a result of their joint creativity, and will lead us out of the impasse. Away from the murder of nature and physical death, forward to the realm of freedom and creativity, to the depths of the ocean and to the stars, to the infinite universe of our inner world. Our forecast for the next 40 years, February 2012. Global Future 2045 Congress is held in Moscow. It is a debate platform for discussion of our civilization's prospects for development. 2012 to 2013, the global economic and social crises are exacerbated. The debates on the global
engineered by globalists
intensifies. New transhumanist movements and parties emerge.
See?
Russia 2045 transforms.
And they get into the end of the family, everything coming up. But again, the transhumanists, they're going to fix all the problems. They've got the implantable tech. It'll fix all these crises that DARPA and the globalists created. Oh, Google, don't be evil. They're just some tech guys that drink beer and got pinball machines. Hey, non-threatening. Oh, Warren Buffett has an ice cream. These are mass killers. These are cold-blooded people. I've been around them. Go back to the rest of it. Here it is.
Into World 2045. Simultaneously, the 2045.com international social network for open innovation is expanding. Here, anyone interested
that's to take your ideas
take part in working on it.
Make sure you don't get it, spy on you.
In the network, there are scientists, scholars, researchers, financiers, and managers.
Oh yeah, there's George Soros, you bet.
2013 to 2014. New centers working on cybernetic technologies for the development of radical life extension rise. The race for immortality starts. Yeah. 2015 to 2020, the avatar is created. a robotic human copy controlled by thought.
That's enough. Computer interface. I'm going to get to more of this on the Nightly News.
You are listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
You've heard Alex explain how the Silver Lungs generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced colloidal silver solutions, yet many are unaware of the entire function of the Silver Lungs system and how it has been designed to deliver your silver solutions anywhere in or on the body. My name is Mario Cifaldi, and I'm the developer of the Silver Lungs generator. Not only does the Silver Lungs system produce endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions, it also comes equipped with the proper applicators and devices needed to deliver your silver solutions directly to key target areas. This includes the eyes, ears, nose, lungs, topically to the skin, and orally for the digestive system. Be sure to watch our new 7-minute video tour of the Silver Lungs system at www.silverlungs.com to learn more about how the Silver Lungs system works. As well, we are always ready to answer any questions you may have. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Well, we've got an article up at Infowars.com right now. Governor Jesse Ventura pointed out that both parties are controlled by the same interest. His new book's out. CNN cut him early. He got canceled by Imus. The system does not want the message, Democrats and Republicans, his new book, it's excellent, getting out there. They are definitely concerned about it. And he joins us for the rest of the hour back from Mexico. Governor, it's good to hear your voice. How you doing?
Hi, Alex. Good to hear yours. I hope everything is good down in Texas.
Oh, yeah. We're going to get into your lawsuit against the liar. We're going to get into the TV show, your book, and so much more. But you know what? Some stations join us in the next segment. So right now, some unorthodox questions. How is Terry? How is the family? And how was Mexico?
Well, the family's doing terrific. Mexico's doing great. You know, all I can say is that I miss not being in the water down there. But then again, it's summertime in Minnesota, so we're the land of 10,000 lakes, so there's plenty of water up here that I can play around in. But I got to tell you this one, Alex. This one, you know, beats all. Okay, I've taken up paddle surfing, right?
Yes.
Well, I wanted to be able to practice on my lake this summer, you know, paddle around on the surfboard. So I went to buy a surfboard, and Minnesota requires you to license them.
Oh, yeah. I went to buy a kayak, and they tried to make me fill out a license form, and I refused to do it here in Texas.
But a surfboard. Unbelievable. And then worse than that, Alex, you're required to wear a life jacket.
You know, they're now trying to make people put dogs in seatbelts and have dogs wear life jackets. The nanny state is here.
Oh, I couldn't believe it. I mean, can you imagine in California or Mexico where the waves get 10 to 15 feet, you're not required to wear a life jacket. You'd get laughed off the beach if you were a surfer with a life jacket on. Minnesota, they don't get a wave over 2 feet unless a big pontoon goes by.
What you do is you order a surfboard online or drive over to Wisconsin. You gotta run for.
I already beat it, Alex. I beat the system. You know how I did it?
Hell,
I gave him my Mexican address. So I, you know, and the guy was great. He said, "Look, if you give me a Minnesota address, I have to license you."
Yeah, but what about wanting? It wasn't even the law. They said, "Well, the police want you to do this." A little bitty one man kayak. At the academy place, everything's got to be tracked, but the banker's laundering all the drug money.
Yeah, exactly. No, I couldn't believe it. You have to register, and get this, the surfboards have no serial numbers on them. So how would they even know it's the correct surfboard?
Oh, it's just pure, they want everything tracked.
That or they want your money.
Oh, Oh, that too. Of course.
I mean, and you know how the law is up here, Alex? Anything over 9.5 feet must be licensed. So if your kids went out and took a couple of 2x4s and built a raft, if it's over 9.5 feet, you got to go register and license it.
I wouldn't put up with that. Well, you didn't put up with that.
I mean, I was stunned. I started laughing. I said, can you imagine if Laird Hamilton came up here to give a paddle surfing lesson and they'd have to put a life jacket on him? A guy who surfs 40 to 50 foot waves in the ocean is considered the greatest big wave surfer in the world. And he would have to put a life jacket on up here.
Well, they're banning 16-ounce drinks now in New York, and talking about, you know, $2,000 fines in Miami if you don't recycle right. I mean, how bad is this nanny state going to get?
Oh, it's going to get worse because we're not standing up to it, you know, and that'll lead right into my book, Who's in Charge? The Democrats and the Republicans.
We're going to cover the book coming up, the lawsuit against the guy that said that he punched you out when you have the owners of the bar, other witnesses, none of this ever happened. The lawsuit goes forward there. What's happening with the TV show? A lot more. Jesse Ventura is our guest. His book is available discounted right now out of the gates at Infowars.com. It's a doozy.
For a long time, you've heard me talk about building your own food supply with eFoods Direct. As a listener, you know why you need to have a supply of the best storable food on the planet. Every day, we document the attempts to take control of our lives. But there's one thing we can all control, your greatest dependency, food. eFoods Direct products are made with only the best ingredients and none of the trash and contaminants like trans fats, GMOs, or MSG. This food is nutrient dense and tastes great. It's simple to make, portable, and has a shelf life of up to 25 years. Now with eFoods Direct, you'll get the most affordable, best-tasting food you can buy. And the new products and pricing will blow you away. Compared to other food sources, including home-cooked meals, you can cut your food cost in half. You just can't afford to ignore this. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex for specials. Don't let this offer pass you by. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. More the best for less, guaranteed.
Sick of the globalist eugenicist control freaks adding poison to your water and laughing as you get sick and die? Start purifying your water with ProPure. My friends, I've done a lot of research, and the best gravity filter out there, bar none, is ProPure, and it's available discounted at Infowars.com. Its filters are silver impregnated to prevent bacterial growth. There's no priming required. It's NSF 42 certified. Optional fluoride filters can reduce fluoride up to 95%. Easy to set up and use. Doesn't require electricity. Purify water from lakes, streams, ponds, and wells. This filter system leaves in beneficial minerals, which is key. Save money by not buying bottled water and avoid BPA that leaches from the plastic. ProPure is the best gravity-fed filter out there. It's what my family uses. Infowars.com already has the lowest price on ProPure. But if you add the promo code WATER at checkout, you get an additional 10% off at Infowars.com. You can also call to order 888-253-3139.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. Put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it, others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans, made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it, others don't. From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Well, time flies. It's hard to believe that I've known Jesse Ventura like six, seven, almost, it's over 7 years now. We were just talking during the break. His dog's 8 years old now. I'm the same his age in dog years. My children are shooting up like weeds. Life is certainly short. And Jesse Ventura is back from Mexico in another great book. He told me the name of the book about a year ago when he started writing it. And boy, it's perfect timing right now. People are really sick of both parties, Democrats and Republicans. No more gangs in government. It's already racing up the New York Times bestseller list. All his books have been New York Times bestsellers. I think one of them was even a number one. He can correct me if I'm wrong. We've got the book at Infowars.com, discounted with his other great books, American Conspiracies and 63 Documents the Government Doesn't Want You to Read, all at Infowars.com and bookstores everywhere. Governor, we've got the waterfront to cover here. TSA, nanny state, weaponized drones, your lawsuit against the Navy SEAL that lied about you and why you went ahead with that. All of it is coming up. Rand Paul, there's so many issues. But let's get into your new book. I think it's one of your best. Where did you come up with the name? And for folks that are listening right now, what does the book break down?
Well, the name, I don't recall who it was. It might have been Senator Dean Barkley, who I appointed to fill the Wellstone seat after Senator Wellstone died. It may have come from him or whatever. But somebody at some point in my life, within the last decade, referred to the two parties as the Democrats and the Republicans. And I thought it was so perfect because when you look, okay, let's go to the Crips and the Bloods, the two street gangs that we use their names. Well, the Crips' colors are blue. Well, what's a Democratic state? It's a blue state, right? The Bloods, naturally, their color is red. Republicans, what's a Republican state? Red state. So they even use the same color code as the street gangs. And I'd like to tell people, these two parties are even more dangerous than the street gangs are. Because the Crips and the Bloods only occupy small little areas of the U.S. where they can be dangerous, the gangs. The Republicans and the Democrats affect each and every one of us every day. Every American is affected by these two gangs, the Democrats and the Republicans. And so I wrote the book because I wanted to expose how horrible it is in light of the Supreme Court's decision that money is free speech and that corporations have the same rights as an individual. It's now completely out of hand, Alex. These corporations are funneling so many millions of dollars into these campaigns, and these two parties have created a system that is based completely on bribery. If you bribe them, you will get what you want. If you don't, well, you're just out of luck then. Now, what troubles me a great deal is that if we commit a bribe offense in the private sector, you go to jail. And yet our whole political system is based upon bribery. And, you know, and money is free speech. Well, I'd love to see the next bank robber, when he goes to trial, say, well, Your Honor, I was simply exercising my right of free speech.
You know?
Because after all, our Supreme Court said that money is free speech. And so clearly our courts are failing us. The Democrats and Republicans, the legislative branch is failing us. The president and the executive branch is failing us. And the fourth branch, the unwritten branch of government, the media, is failing us. Why? Because the media, it was interesting. I saw Dan Rather on the other day. And if you'll recall, he got fired because he reported on George Bush the kid, his service record. Well, every bit of it was true, and Dan Rather got fired for telling the truth. And the other thing, the point Rather made was, back then there were probably 40 media outlets giving us information. Today you're down to about four corporations that control all the media in the United States. And that's dangerous because they're control the corporate, and that's the definition of fascism. The corporations are controlling our government. They're controlling our media. If you read the works of General Smedley Butler, the two-time Congressional Medal of Honor winner, the most decorated Marine in history, he died in the 40s. Smedley Butler said, I didn't fight for the American people. I fought for the United Fruit Corporation. When they didn't get cooperation in South and Central America, they sent in the Marines to get it.
And that's what your book breaks down. And you're right. I mean, the Crimson Bloods might kill 500 people or less a year. I was looking up some of the crime statistics. It was more than 1,000 a year or so during the peak in the mid and late 1980s. The gangs that run our country are militarizing the police, federalizing them, torturing people, passing the NDAA, saying they'll kill citizens when they want, saying they'll kill U.S. citizens with weaponized drones inside the U.S. They're taxing the daylights out of us. They're spying on us without warrants and just admitting it. Bill Gates is coming out with bracelets for students that will determine emotional cognitive response, tracking their waves, their brain waves. I mean, this is like a science fiction nightmare, and the Democrips and Republicans got caught insider trading, as you know, Governor,
sure.
And they said, oh, it's legal for us. And then you've got LaGrande over in the IMF saying she's exempt from taxes, but Greece needs to pay more. I mean, we've got a criminal class running wild. How do we reverse it? I know the book addresses that. What's your ideas to stop these people?
Well, the first thing we could do, the most important thing for anyone that wants to strike out as a patriot against where our government's going today, stop voting for them. That's the simple thing you can do. Quit voting for Democrats, Republicans. I am going to fully endorse my former colleague, Governor Gary Johnson of New Mexico. He's a terrific man. He has the endorsement of the Libertarian Party, and he will get my vote. I will campaign relentlessly for him because Ron Paul apparently is going to end it at the end of the Republican convention. I don't hear any word at all that he's going to go independent at all. The Libertarians made their move already. And so I will support Governor Johnson completely. He's quit the Republican Party because they wouldn't even allow him to debate or even participate because he wasn't the chosen one. And let me add for people so they realize something. Recall and go back to when the Obama-McCain election took place, and of course President Obama won. Immediately upon that, we started seeing ads on television about the Mormon religion. Remember those?
Yes.
All over TV, we started getting influx of the
giant billboards, giant.
I'm also a Mormon.
Yeah, giant billboards, too.
Oh, yeah. Well, that was to prepare us. They already had Romney picked out at that point. The Republican, all this debates was baloney. Always remember this. You don't pick your president. The two gangs do. You'll get a gang member from one side and a gang member from the other side, and then you're expected to choose which one of those gang members you want to be the president.
And they are a gang.
People can now change that and vote for Governor Johnson to be our next president.
Governor Ventura, I think this is an excellent idea that you have to really try to brand things as the Republicans being the Bloods and the Democrats being the Crips. It's really starting to get political traction out there, and I think that's why you told me off air you're running into a lot of censorship. You're having your interviews cut short or canceled. We're going to talk about that. But since we got into the 2012 race, Ron Paul is not as hardcore on a lot of issues now. Rand came out and endorsed Mitt Romney. His father did not endorse in the presidential election, of course, McCain. This is a big departure. People are upset about that. What's your take on it?
Well, how do you not endorse your own father? I mean, Ron Paul hasn't officially left the race. They haven't even had their convention yet. So my view is that, you know, the Tea Party's phony. I cover that in this book. You know, they've been taken over by the Koch brothers. What maybe started off as a good idea, then you ended up with Glenn Beck, Sarah Palin, and all them. The same as the Wall Street movement is trying to be co-opted by the Democrats. Well, these movements, you can't allow that to happen. And that is typical gang warfare. The gangs will absorb any other gang that comes into their territory. So these both of these parties act just like the street gangs do.
Well, that's what politics was in Rome. I mean, they were literal street gangs.
Yeah, well, that's what you have here now, you know, between these two. And the American people, I can't tell them enough, don't vote for Democrats or Republicans. Don't vote for, hell, I'd vote for the communists before I'd vote for them.
Well, they're bankster run as well, Jesse, if you go to the Ford Foundation. But exactly, they're trying to control every angle of this. What do you think Rand Paul was thinking endorsing Mitt Romney when Mitt Romney is financed by the very same people that Obama is? I mean, that's the real gang, are these big mega banks.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And the thing is, they're not responsible for anything. We can't even know now who the amounts of money and who they come from. Here's the thing I have, Alex, and I know it sounds silly, but it's very good. I think all presidential candidates should be required to wear NASCAR racing suits. And I say that because when you look at, like, Jimmy Johnson, the great NASCAR racer, you can see all his sponsors right in front of you because he has patches.
Yeah, that means wear it on your sleeve.
Exactly. Yeah, he has patches. That way we as voters can see who owns these politicians.
That's a great idea. Make
force them to wear NASCAR racing suits so that we know who owns them. We know who has contributed to them. And that way we can be informed voters when we go to the polls.
All right, we got 40 more minutes with him. He's not censored here. We'll continue getting into his powerful new book, available at InfoWars.com, I should add, Democrats and Republicans, No More Gangs in Government. It's powerful. And we're going to get into his lawsuit against the Navy SEAL, the book published by News Corp slandering him, libeling him. It's all coming up.
We all know there are secrets behind closed doors in every relationship. And one of the biggest is that men are losing libido or sexual desire, especially if you're a man over 40. The problem could be declining testosterone levels. Remember, it's testosterone that makes a man in every way. That's why they created T-Gen. It contains an all-natural ingredient that will safely boost your testosterone. You need healthy levels of testosterone to have a good mood and a positive, energetic mind. Call now and receive a free bottle of T-Gen. Call 800-577-8644 right now for more details. Call 800-577-8644 for your free one-month supply. That's 800-577-8644 for your free bottle now. In a study of exercising men using the ingredient in T-Gen, 85% reported an improvement in sexual desire. Don't wait. Call now. Call 800-577-8644. 800-577-8644. 800-577-8644. Call now.
American gardeners and fellow patriots, make the right choice with your money, time, and your family food supply. Choose 100% pure heirloom seeds in the Survival Seed Vault from MyPatriotSupply.com. Why spend more? The Survival Seed Vault from MyPatriotSupply.com is only $37.95 and includes 20 varieties of pure, hardy, easy-to-grow heirloom seeds. Yes, only $37.95. That's 70% less than our competitors. You could buy three Survival Seed Vaults for less than one of theirs. The Survival Seed Vault from MyPatriotSupply.com includes detailed planting and seed saving instructions and ships same day. Plus, all orders over $49 ship free. MyPatriotSupply.com is American owned by patriots like you, passionate about freedom and preparedness. Call now, 866-229-0927. That's 866-229-0927. Or discover more emergency preparedness items when you order at MyPatriotSupply.com. Choose the original. Choose the Survival Seed Vault at MyPatriotSupply.com.
Hello, this is Ty Bollinger, author of the best-selling book, Cancer, Step Outside the Box. I want you to know some very important information. In 1985, President Ronald Reagan requested that Carnivora be sent directly to the White House at a time when only the president could obtain this world-class healer. Now, 27 years later, Carnivora capsules are used around the world to keep people healthy. Now you can protect yourself and your loved ones in this age of superbugs with 17 naturally occurring compounds that instinctively respond to abnormal cells only without harming a single normal cell. If you want to stay healthy, now's your chance to literally wake up your critical immune cells to attack harmful invaders that don't belong in your body. Call 1-866-VENUS-FLY or order from carnivora.com. That's carnivora.com. That's 1-866-836-8735, 1-866-VENUS-FLY, or visit carnivora.com. Protect your immune system. It's the only one you've got.
survival is not about the end of the world. It's not about a hypothetical plane crash or the latest violent storm. Survival is about the satisfaction of knowing you can take care of yourself and your family in any situation, anytime, anywhere. CampingSurvival.com was started in 1956. No, not the .com part, the survival part. CampingSurvival.com has over 17,000 urban, wilderness, and preparedness items, supreme customer service, very low shipping, and no games. We look around to make sure we have the lowest prices, and CampingSurvival.com is 100% USMC veteran-owned. Don't base your survival on the latest spring up on the internet company. Do business with an authority on survival. CampingSurvival.com. Use coupon code GCN at checkout, and CampingSurvival.com will take 5% off your order. CampingSurvival.com. Confidence born of preparation.
Governor Jesse Ventura, best-selling author, movie star, TV host, is our guest. We're going to talk about the TV show. Where is it? Supposed to be out months ago. Third season. Got great ratings. Top ratings for a new show. We're going to be talking to him about that. I'm obviously in the series, in the research. Amazing topics covered. That's coming up. But, Governor, let's get into this right now. You filed suit back in February against Chris Kyle, the Navy SEAL sniper, who said that you came into the big famous Navy SEAL bar and said, I'm glad Navy SEALs are dying. Of course, you've talked about Navy SEALs many times, how you hate that the troops are dying, period. I've seen you talk to veterans and get tears in your eyes at the airport. I knew that was a lie. I confronted him on air. He kind of backtracked when I was on Opie and Anthony's show. I was trying to feel him out. You've now sued him. You can't tell the listeners everything you've told me, but you got this guy in your crosshairs big time. You were in court with him last week. Tell us what's happening with your lawsuit against Harper, well, against Chris Kyle. I was saying it should be against Harper Collins. That's News Corp. That's Fox News, because they're the ones that got him on air. And I'll bet they're the ones that got him to say this. They're the ones that Ghost wrote it. That's admitted. So that would be my target, Governor. But tell us where we are right now.
Well, they still may end up the target. I mean, we have the ability to add whoever we want to the lawsuit. And the first thing I would like to say, Alex, is quite simple. If this had happened, if this was reality, I would not be suing him. But because it did not happen, it's a made-up story. Unfortunately, now the remedy I can get is to go into the federal court system and go to trial, put it in front of a jury, and I will let a jury decide who's telling the truth and what witnesses. I mean, I have witnesses of the people who were with me all night long, and they are all Navy SEALs. They're my generation of SEALs. They're not the young ones that this guy's a member of. And we'll let a jury decide. But, I've been out to McPease since. When I came back from Mexico, I made a purpose trip to go there to photograph the patio and everything like that for the trial. And I had people there telling me that this never happened.
Well, you said the owner. Well, there's also Terry Moy, who is one of the famous Navy SEAL trainers. You weren't going to sue, you told me off air the other day. And please repeat that if it's okay.
Well, but I was going to sue, but Instructor Moy gave me more, and I've always obeyed his orders. He's my first phase instructor when I went through BUDS, Basic Underwater Demolition SEAL Training. And Moy told me, he said, take this guy to the root. Take him all the way. Well, I don't not obey my first phase instructor even today. If he tells me something, I'm probably going to do it. So, but he made me feel good telling me that none of the old-timers believe this at all. They all think it's a bunch of BS. They know it's a bunch of BS. I have never, ever blamed the military. I look at the military men and women as victims. They're victims of political, poor politicians.
But you've said that 20 times on my show before and other shows. You always say that. That's why when I heard that, I knew it was pure bull. And also saying that others said you were drinking. I know you haven't had alcohol in many years. I've been
10 years. I have not had alcohol for 10 years. And get this. Here's the thing to look at, Alex. I mean, if something like this would have happened in 06, how would it be contained and we would only learn about it in 2012 or 2011? 2012, I guess he revealed it in January. You mean to tell me this happened five, six years ago and not one word of it leaked out? Baloney.
It would have been in the newspaper the next day.
Absolutely. I mean, I'm a former governor. If I'd have been decked in the bar in Coronado, that the police, and in his book, he even said the police were there.
But let's not forget what happened 2 weeks before, and you called me about it and, yep. And wanted to come on air to get it out. News Corps again came out and said you had been in road rage with the police in California going to the airport when everyone knows you hadn't flown for over a year at that point.
A year and a half, and the last time I was in California was last July for my birthday. I celebrated my 60th birthday with actor Harry Dean Stanton, who has his birthday's the day before mine.
I was there.
85, and I drove to California to do that. I did not get on an airplane. And so there's another lie that has come out, you know, and naturally I think that happened because I was rattling my sword about possibly joining Ron Paul, and if he became an independent, that I would consider being his running mate. So anytime I rattle my sword on national politics, it seems there's a concerted effort to defame me.
Yeah, you're road raging when you were on record in Minnesota. They say you're in California road raging. When they know you're going into Mexico and are off the phone for a few days, they say that you were saying you're glad Navy SEALs have died. I mean, they are really trying to swift boat you. Stay there. I want to see if you agree with that statement on the other side. We'll get into all these other big issues. Stay with us. We'll be back with Governor Ventura.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
If you want an American company with American products made by Americans, here is the Cal Bend Soap Company. Alex and his staff have used these pure soap products for years. These all-natural soaps are made from the highest quality vegetable and coconut oils that are earth-friendly and safe. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog. Buy the 1 to 2 month sample package and enjoy soaps that are twice as good as what you're using now. Or save big with a 1 to 2 year supply of soaps for all your cleaning needs. This is an amazing deal. You can save thousands of dollars and you will love the way real soap makes you feel. See them on the web at 5starsoap.com or call 800-340-7091 for a free catalog.
For a long time, you've heard me talk about building your own food supply with eFoods Direct. As a listener, you know why you need to have a supply of the best storable food on the planet. Every day, we document the attempts to take control of our lives. But there's one thing we can all control, your greatest dependency, food. eFoods Direct products are made with only the best ingredients and none of the trash and contaminants like trans fats, GMOs, or MSG. This food is nutrient dense and tastes great. It's simple to make, portable, and has a shelf life of up to 25 years. Now with eFoods Direct, you'll get the most affordable, best tasting food you can buy. And the new products and pricing will blow you away. Compared to other food sources, including home cooked meals, you can cut your food cost in half. You just can't afford to ignore this. Call 800-409-5633. Or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex for specials. Don't let this offer pass you by. Call 800-409-5633 or eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. More the best for less guaranteed.
This is Alex Jones with 5 good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number 1, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number 2, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number 3. In some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number 4. Dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number 5. A solar power generator provides powerful backup, insurance, and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun. So go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
All right, we're not going to dwell on this too much because Governor Ventura wants it all to come out in court. That's what his lawyers have advised. I agree with him. It's going to come out. Depositions have begun. I don't know how much Ventura can repeat here, but do you feel that you've been swift-boated? And when was the last time you were in a barroom fight, Governor?
I absolutely feel that I've been swift-boated. There's no doubt about it. And what was interesting when it happened to Senator Kerry, I learned later that his main accuser did not even arrive in Vietnam until months after Senator Kerry had already come home to the States. So the guy wasn't even there to question whether the senator had earned his medals or not. And besides, you don't put yourself in for medals. Your commanding officer does. So it was really, so yeah, I feel I've been swift-boated. There's no doubt about it. But as I said, I wouldn't be suing the guy if the story were true. And the story is completely false, and therefore my only alternative to clear my name and to attempt to get it cleared is to take him to court, and I'll let a jury decide who they want to believe.
Can we talk about your lawyers, if they're confident?
Absolutely they're confident. That's all I'll say. They're very confident, or I wouldn't be going to court.
No, I know, but you told me that off air, but I wanted to make sure that wasn't...
They feel very good about the case, that they could win the case, but you never know for certain.
Yeah, just to be clear, I'm not leading Jesse Ventura. I'm trying to get him to repeat stuff he's told me without letting out what he's told me. But I tell you, the right thing to do is Chris Kyle needs to go ahead and go public now and admit the truth before this gets much deeper. Just go ahead and tell us what News Corp told you to do.
Well, it would be my preference, Alex, not to go to court because court gets very expensive, but he leaves me no choice. I mean, he won't admit that the story's made up for whatever reason. It's not true. And so I'm left with no alternative but to go to federal court and let a jury decide it. But
When I first met you 7 years ago, I heard some propaganda on the web, so I went and looked it up myself, made some phone calls, and found out you were telling the truth. But just to bring this up here, and then we'll get back into all the other issues in the book that's so powerful. The last three have been so good, so informative. I don't know which one's my favorite, but Ward Monckton, he is a hereditary peer. It's listed on the royal websites in England. His dad was a famous lord, and he's Lord Christopher Monckton, an anti-global warming guy. You interviewed him for one of your TV shows. They ran a big hoax saying he's not a lord, and he made it up, and counting on the public being ignorant. So they say you're not a Navy SEAL. Well, I was like, wait a minute. Underwater Demolition Team, the History Channel, says that's what started the SEALs. He went through SEALs training. He was, in the Vietnam era. And I went and looked and found out that it was people that didn't like your anti-war stance came out and said you were never in the SEALs. Next, they may say that I'm not even who I say I am either. We have to defend each other when they come out with these hoaxes. If they come out, folks, and say I'm a drug dealer, it's not true. I mean, I have a pretty boring life. I mean, it scares me to know what are they going to make up about us next, Governor?
Yeah, absolutely. And in this country today, you have to be prepared to defend yourself, especially with the internet. Anything can be put on the internet. The internet's a great thing. Don't get me wrong. It's tremendous because it gives us a great deal of information that we don't get with the mainstream media. But on the flip side, just like anything, there's an upside and there's a downside. On the downside, you have to be very careful what you believe and choose to believe because anyone can lie on the internet. There is nothing there, no truth detection device that you can apply to the internet.
Well, sure,
know absolutely if you're hearing the truth or not.
It's just like the mainstream media. You've got to go to the original sources.
Yep.
And that brings us to the next issue. Again, you've told me a lot of stuff in confidence, which I appreciate because I've been part of the show 3 seasons. We've gotten to be friends. A lot of crazy stuff went on behind the scenes, but I've been sworn to secrecy about the things that happened, not just the congressman calling or Homeland Security threatening Time Warner, the parent company of of True TV. We know they pulled your Homeland Security piece on the FEMA camps. Since that happened, the Army governor has admitted they have re-education camps. We got a document 2 months ago. The Army responded, said, yes, that's a classified document. So now you've been validated, but they had that pulled, erased off TiVo, never re-aired, as the other episodes do dozens of times. What is happening with the third installment of conspiracy theory?
Well, unfortunately, we finished it all in November. Normally, it would go on the air in January. It's now sitting there being nitpicked with more, you know, I think it's a delay tactic. I now believe 50-50 that the 8 shows we did this fall will never see the light of day. Because it's already June. We had them done in November. You know? And they're supposedly still doing the fine-tuning of editing. Well, give me a break. You can get that done in 2 to 3 weeks, a month at the moment.
Well, they made them totally re-edit it and then still didn't like it. But both shows were big hits. Big hits.
Well, both seasons have been outstanding, and this would have been the third season of 8 more shows. But I don't know if they're ever going to see the light of day or not. You know, it's True TV has the right to not put them on, certainly, and I see no indication that they're going to be on. They may, you know, I don't know, maybe they'll wait till fall and put them on during the election time. That'd be wonderful. But I don't know. I mean, they've sure, you know, they've gone out of their normal mode, because normally we finish them in November and they air right away in January.
And the major TV publications reported that both seasons got record viewers for new seasons. 1.7, 1.8 million viewers for that channel is as big as it basically gets for them. Huge hits and millions spent to make them. And now the question is, do you think putting pressure on them, people contacting them, will have any effect? Or do you think outside pressure has been placed on them?
I think that could work the opposite. That could make them not put them on. If the people who are deciding because they're too controversial or they have information that the public doesn't want to get, and if maybe if the public starts demanding it, that'll make them even lock them up more. I don't know. I don't know which way to go on that, Alex. Certainly people are entitled to express their opinion. If they would like to contact them, I'm not going to tell them not to. You can do what you want. I'm a great believer in personal freedom. And every one of your listeners should have the ability to have personal freedom. If they want to write a letter asking what's happened to conspiracy theory, why are you sitting on it? Why won't you air them the way Jesse Ventura and them edited them instead of re-editing them and, you know, dumbing them down, which is really what they're trying to do, I think. They're trying to really dumb them down.
Yeah. It's I've been told the behind-the-scenes stuff. I better just keep my mouth shut because it was told in confidence. It's pretty bad. But that's a sign of success. Look, let's go back here on this subject because a lot of people don't know about this, even though you've talked about it some. Tell folks what MSNBC did with the golden handcuffs.
With the what?
You know, how they gave you the contract, basically.
Oh, okay. I didn't catch it. Yeah. No, when I first came out of office, I was the hottest commodity out there. I didn't seek a second term. I was the voice of the independent. You know, as Eleanor Cliff called me, the high priest of the third party movement. And so they got in a bidding war between Fox, MSNBC, and CNN, which would give me a show 5 days a week on television in the evening. And MSNBC won out. Well, we went together. We followed everything they wanted done. They even sent, I wanted it shot in Minneapolis because I felt it would be nice to get a Midwest perspective for a change rather than the East or West Coast where they do most of their stuff. And they agreed to it. So they even sent an MSNBC guy out to work with us and create the whole show. Well, we created, did everything they wanted, and Eric Sorensen, who was in charge, came out. He didn't even watch the show we did and told us that he wouldn't put us on the air. Well, then let me back up a little. When they first hired me, Eric took me to the Super Bowl in San Diego, and we were driving up to Los Angeles then. And in the car, he told me that after he hired me, he got 2 phone calls from people very high up in Washington. He would never reveal to me who they were, but he said that these wanted to know why they were giving me a national forum, you know, a show on national TV.
Wow.
Well, lo and behold, I never got it because they pulled the plug on the show, basically. They relegated us to a few Saturday shows where we, I think we had four or five shows on Saturday at 5 o'clock. It was still the second highest rated show they had, right behind Hardball with Chris Matthews, with no promotion, no nothing. And then they simply cut me, and because I was under contract with them for 3 years, and I honor my contract stated that I could not do any news shows, nor could I participate in anything on cable television at all. So in essence, they bound and gagged me, and they paid me the entire money, and I will just say this, I was paid like a professional athlete on that level. So they paid me the entire 3 years. My checks came. Even my assistant got paid for the entire 3 years. But I had to then, as I said, honor my contract. And so for 3 years, I could not speak out on anything.
Yeah, you were the hottest commodity out there, I remember. And they literally, at the time, I said on air, he's off the air, that's golden handcuffs. They do that to executives and people that they're scared of that'll go start a new company. You were given golden handcuffs, Governor.
Yeah, I'm sure I was. And then, of course, the contract ended, and that 3 years later, that's when you saw me reemerge again when I wrote the book, you know, Don't Start the Revolution Without Me, the first book. And I then started, of course, going on TV shows and all that because they no longer contracted.
And that got high ratings, and you destroyed Hannity. You do really good in person when people get nasty because you're so calm and work so well on your feet. Now I'm noticing they don't put you on as much, even though you were a sought-after guest. Let's talk about what's happening now. They're really scared of this idea of the Republicans and Democrats being gangs.
Well, like I said, Fox News won't have me on at all. They're nighttime, they're big people. MSNBC will not have me on. They're now the liberal side. They're the Democrat side. The other's the Republican side. Those two, the only TV. Now, Fox News puts me on, but I think they're a different department. I am doing a couple on Fox News, but that's a different ball of wax, I think. And CNN will have me on. Although this morning on CNN, I was supposed to get three segments because they asked me for three songs to lead in. So I gave them a Whole Lot of Love by Led Zeppelin, Hey Joe by Jimi Hendrix, and Sympathy for the Devil by the Stones. Well, the only one played was Whole Lot of Love because they had me for one brief three-minute segment this morning. I believe I was cut there even at CNN, although I did have a terrific interview last night with Piers Morgan.
And then you also got cut with, it doesn't really matter, he didn't have many listeners, but Don Imus.
Oh, yeah, Don Imus. They wanted me to have five songs, so I chose five songs by Rage Against the Machine. And people who don't follow that era of rock, they were banned by Clear Channel. None of their music was allowed to be played prior to and during the Iraq War. So, and I'm a huge fan now of Tom Morello, the lead guitar player. I believe he is our next Woody Guthrie. He's our next Bob Dylan. He's our next Bruce Springsteen. You know, he's out there. He stood with the Occupy Wall Street people. He flew right.
No, I know. I've interviewed him.
Stand with the union workers in Madison against Governor Walker there.
I've had a chance to interview him a few times because every time I'm at a protest or something, hey, there's Tom Morello. Do you live at these things, buddy?
Well, Tom Morello to me is a great American.
Oh, no, I'm saying he's this very successful big rock star, sold tens of millions of albums, and there he is in a lot of dangerous places, quite frankly. I mean, I see him quite often out there, regular guy, with the people.
Well, I would love to get a chance to meet him. Like I said, he's one of my new rock and roll heroes.
Well, he's absolutely down to earth, Jesse. You'd love him. Shifting gears, we talked about this yesterday on the phone, and you laughed and said it doesn't surprise me, but I actually have a big stack of these. Congresswoman lashes out at TSA for hiring pedophiles and child pornographers, and it turns out key head TSA agents over whole gates and airports are defrocked priests, child pornographers, convicted rapists. So this is being done on purpose. And I've got a whole stack of news. You've been out of the country. I want to read this to you. Again, defrocked priest hired as the head in Philadelphia. Representative John Micah calls TSA, the little bastard child. The TSA, again, every 2 days is being caught raping, stealing, molesting, running child porn, running prostitutes. I mean, who else would want to grab people's genitals all day? What is your take on the TSA? And now 2 years you haven't flown, Governor.
Well, you know, I don't know about any of that stuff, Alex, so I'm not going to comment on it. I can only speak to my own experience and how I feel, and that is this. I'm outraged that it cost me $20,000 to go to court in front of a federal judge to be told she didn't have jurisdiction over a constitutional question. And that's what they do with anyone that challenges in our court system, the TSA and Homeland Security. They don't have jurisdiction. Well, people need to understand clearly, when you go to any airport in the United States today, you are not protected by the Constitution or the Bill of Rights. In other words, they can do anything they want to you out there, and there's nowhere you can seek redress because the courts will not hear it.
It's a lawless criminal zone, but let me raise this to you, because I understand you've been out of the country until a few weeks ago. This is the Congresswoman Marsha Blackburn. She listed 50 pedophile crimes of the TSA. I mean, this is in the news. So I'm saying, if that's true, I mean, you told me off air you're not surprised. But no, sir, I mean, it is true that they're finding a bunch of them that are being put in leadership positions are pervs. What do you think of that?
Well, why wouldn't they? I believe that that's why pedophiles become Catholic priests. I believe they're pedophiles first, and they become priests because pedophiles are nothing but predators. They're hunters.
Yes.
They hunt children. They can't be cured. And so they need to put themselves in a position where the hunting is good. And that's why I believe when you got pedophile priests, they were pedophiles long before they became priests.
Yes.
And so why wouldn't they join the TSA? Where they can grope little children and where they have the government's blessing to do so. You know, that's one of the places where Lou Dobbs and I stand hand in hand. Lou Dobbs said, thank you, Governor, when I brought the lawsuit. And in fact, I'll be doing Lou's show. So it'll be interesting to see, you know, what he says to me about the dismissal of my lawsuit the way it was. But again, it doesn't surprise me because pedophiles are predators and they're going to go wherever the hunting is best to satisfy their sick, demented minds when they should belong in jail. They'll put pot smokers in jail, but they'll turn pedophiles loose in the neighborhood.
Well said, Governor. You're absolutely right. I just wanted you to repeat what you said privately on the phone yesterday. And yes, that is the case, folks. It is a pedophile epidemic. The Congresswoman is exposing it. This is really coming out, and these are abusers. And they're not all pedophiles. Some of them like good-looking women. I got one in Las Vegas who clearly liked men. I mean, it is disgusting.
In an emergency situation, would you drink contaminated water? You could if you had the amazing Life Straw from MyPatriotSupply.com. Life Straw is the most advanced personal water filter available today. It filters contaminated water from almost any source. Life Straw is lightweight and compact, perfect for hiking, camping, or in an emergency like a flood. Life Straw is easy to clean, comes with a 1-year warranty, and has been used worldwide since 2005. Get the amazing Life Straw personal water filter at MyPatriotSupply.com. Plus, check out Survival Seed Vault, 20 seed varieties for only $37.95, Tattler canning lids, long-term storable foods as low as $69.95, and much more at MyPatriotSupply.com. Enjoy stress-free shipping on all orders over $49. Call 866-229-0927 or visit MyPatriotSupply.com. That's 866-229-0927, MyPatriotSupply.com, for emergency preparedness, self-reliance, and food independence.
Love gardening but don't love seeing your hard work destroyed by wildlife? Then use the number one most effective deer and rabbit repellent you can buy, PlantSkid. PlantSkid repellent protects gardens, trees, and landscaping by emitting an odor that browsing animals associate with predators. So animals avoid plants before they nibble, not after. PlantSkid is made in the U.S. from non-toxic, 100% organic, environment, and pet-friendly ingredients. Other repellents wash off in the rain, not PlantSkid. It's guaranteed to outlast all other repellents. PlantSkid was the first animal repellent to be OMRI listed organic and now comes in liquid spray, powder concentrate, or easy-to-use granular. Just sprinkle around your garden. For proven protection from deer, rabbits, squirrels, and other small rodents, use PlantSkid. Member tested and recommended by the National Home Gardening Club. Find a dealer near you at PlantSkid.com. That's PlantSkyd.com. Ask about our new vole repellent when you call 800-252-6051. That's 800-252-6051. PlantSkid. Proven plant protection, guaranteed or your money back.
Healthy soils grow healthy plants. So before you plant your survival garden this year, is your soil healthy? Maximize your crisis garden soil with EM1 from Terraganics. EM1 organic soil conditioner, fertilizer amendment, and compost accelerant provides healthier gardens and faster, efficient garden composting. EM1 from Terraganics.com quickly improves soil structure by increasing nutrient availability and converting organic matter into soil humus. This improves seed germination and root growth, improves plant quality, size, color, flavor, nutrient value of fruits and vegetables, and improves shelf life. And when rain is not in the forecast, no worries. EM1 improves moisture retention in soils, helping reduce drought stress. Just like you prepare all else, prepare your crisis garden for maximum yields with EM1 from Terraganics.com. Order now at Terraganics.com or call toll-free 866-369-3678. That's 866-369-3678. Terraganics, life's getting better.
The Gov was just telling me he did 45 days in Mexico with no TV. That's got to be good. How was that?
Well, it was very enjoyable, really. I call it flushing your brain out. And I tell you, Alex, more people ought to do it. You know, take a week off and don't watch television for a week and learn what else goes on in the world besides what's on that magical tube, because it controls our lives far too much.
It does. Going back during the break, some of the best radio is happening off air. I said, what do you want to cover in the last 5-minute segment? And you said, Rand Paul, that's terrible. So we'd already mentioned that, but you wanted to say some more about that, and then I want to ask you about drones. I mean, what do you think this is going to do to Rand Paul and Ron Paul endorsing Romney?
I don't know. I mean, Ron Paul hasn't endorsed Romney, has he?
No, but he kind of announced, oh, now the campaign is lost the same day, so it's coordinated.
Well, then, you know, it's going to be pretty sad because, you know, I thought that, you know, the hope of an independent would show up. And again, that's why I urge everybody, vote for Governor Gary Johnson, the former governor of New Mexico. We served together. I know him well. He's a wonderful, honest man. He's the libertarian candidate. And if people want to rebel in this country, don't vote for the Democrats or Republicans. Vote for the libertarian, Gary Johnson. That'll send a shockwave through him. You know, even if he does well, he doesn't even have to win. If he gets, you know, say 10 million more votes or 20 million more votes than they would expect him to get, it'll scare the hell out of him.
And then people say, well, Obama will win. Well, they're all the same. Let it get worse.
Let me be clear with the public. They're paid off by both sides. It does not matter with the Democrats and Republicans. It makes no difference who you elect.
No, I know that. But that's the point I was making is that it's a total illusion. But specifically, what did you say during the break, though?
Well, I don't know. Refresh my memory. I get fired up, I forget.
Well, no, you were just saying you didn't like what Rand did. I want your take
specifically. I don't like, you know, that he would not endorse his own father. That's pretty strange to me. I mean, Ron hasn't officially dropped out of the race until after the convention. Why would he throw his support to Mitt Romney?
Well, that's why I'm upset, is that Ron, the day that happened, said, well, we won't win with the delegates, so we kind of halfway conceded, but they never fully do it because they want to keep the troops all fired up, and that's kind of like getting your dog excited. You're taking it for a walk and then throwing it in the closet. I don't like teasing people, but again, I still care about them. I just hope they get back on the straight and narrow, no compromise. Drones, Governor, 30,000 armed drones, local police getting them. They've got one called a Switchblade that's got like a hand grenade in the nose, a little bitty one they're going to use on. Us. They've announced the military will be on the streets of America. What's your take on the whole police state, all of this?
Well, it's horrid. You know, I talked about it, and I when that bill came forward, the defense bill that turned the American military, I think it was Senate Bill 1768, I don't know if my numbers are exact, but sponsored by John McCain and Carl Levin from Michigan, the Democrat. Outrageous. That defies the Constitution to me. You know, it spits on the Constitution of the United States, and it passed overwhelmingly. So it shows you again. again, the Democrats, Crips, and the Republicans, they use the Constitution like toilet paper.
They are treasonous traitors. They are gangs that have hijacked our country.
Exactly. And it's like using it as toilet paper. The Constitution means nothing to them. And that's why we have to get, we the people are going to have to take care of ourselves, because they're not going to. And these drones, how dare them have flying drones going around our country? It's bad enough they got us under surveillance. You know, clearly they don't trust us for whatever reason.
Well, it's also very cowardly that they're going to have armies of flying and rolling drones attack us. I mean, with our money.
Yeah, that's your tax dollars being spent to go against you. You know, I always laugh about what happened in Iran. Imagine for a moment, Alex, if, say, Hugo Chavez got an unmanned drone and flew it over United States airspace and it crashed here. We would declare war on him. And yet we do it to Iran. We fly over.
Well said, Governor. Well said.
Hypocrisy is ridiculous.
It is.
Visit GCNlive.com today.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones, and I want to tell you about the Silver Lungs Generator. Now you can produce pure and endless colloidal silver and deliver the solution directly into the bloodstream by breathing the solution through the lungs. The respiratory system is the first line of defense for airborne pathogens and viruses. The Silver Lungs Generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced nano-silver solutions and also delivers the silver nanoparticles instantly into the bloodstream. With continued...